Yo, what's going on, guys? Good evening. Welcome to The Jam with K-Magic 101 and King Italian. We got special guest Professor Broman, who will profess all the broman. I don't know what that means.
What does that mean?
It doesn't mean anything, dude. It's good to see you guys. Thank you for coming out tonight. We're gonna get started on our topics of nothing, like, immediately, so let's fucking get right into it, man.
Well, first off,
we're in the library tonight.
It's yeah. Very fancy. It's important.
Yeah, we're in. Yeah.
I didn't bring my smoking pipe, but we're good. There's a new channel in Discord if you want to be on live. What's it called?
The Jam Lounge. The Jam Lounge.
That's where you wait. Don't wait in the waiting room. Wait in the Jam Lounge.
Uh huh.
So if you want to be on live, if you're listening live.
Yeah.
Show's still on iTunes. Thank you guys for listening to it. It's been great. Great.
It's been going good.
Five stars.
Ton somehow.
Of downloads. So thank you. Keep doing that. Keep downloading. Keep listening.
We got in new and noteworthy.
We are number one in new and noteworthy in gaming last week.
Yeah.
Well, nice.
Freaking amazing.
Congratulations. Yeah.
You were number one for a while.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, then we stopped doing it. Because it's a seasonal thing, you know.
Just thought I'd let you know that.
Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah. So tradition.
Do the thing.
I got this because it was really cheap and I didn't know how it was going to turn out. This is hard apple pie flavored beverage. and it has...
You know, that's actually really fucking hilarious because you know what goes really great with hard apple pies? What I brought, which is cinnamon whiskey.
Cinnamon
because
whiskey.
Because fuck your bad beer rules.
I feel like I should...
I'm not part of the jam.
Should I try mixing
I'm gonna
this?
Fuck it up.
Are you gonna...
I'm going to mix it.
I think I'm going to mix
no,
it.
No, I'm definitely going to mix
it's
it.
It's Sprecher... Hard apple pie.
Sprecher.
So, go ahead and open yours
malted
over there, boys.
Malted beverage. This is yeah. Might as well be old English.
I thought that said Sprucifer for some reason.
Sprucifer?
I don't know. I read that as an F and an I.
That's definitely not Sprucifer.
I don't know.
Cinnamon and apple beer. Yeah, man. That's like a... I've had
hard
that.
Hard apple pie, dude.
How is it?
Right, do we take it? Do you guys yeah. drink it all together
no,
at the same time?
Do what you gotta do.
No, you do what you gotta do.
Ooh, that's disgusting.
Oh, that tastes like diarrhea, and then it has an after, there's a finish.
It tastes like what you would shit out after Thanksgiving dinner's dessert. Oh, that's bad.
I like it.
It's really bad.
I like it.
You like this?
That's
yeah, it
gross.
Tastes like a dessert.
That's like liking gravy soda.
I like ooh, this.
It tastes like gravy.
Did I tell you when I had buffalo chicken wings soda?
Yeah. Yeah, you told me that.
It was so
and
bad.
You tried, you...
It was so bad. Oh my god, it didn't taste like buffalo chicken at all, buffalo chicken.
I'm required soda. To drink all of this?
Yeah, oh, I mean, like, unless we all tap out.
I'm not tapping out.
No,
I'm tapping in.
This isn't Four Loko, I can finish this.
All yeah, right, maybe, Kevin, you want to
yeah,
me a chop?
Do that thing. All right.
You want a little nipper?
No, I'm good.
No.
You don't
no,
be,
he doesn't
want
to nip.
A man?
He doesn't want to nip.
You
want to
be a man?
Fine, we'll nip a little bit.
Nip a little bit!
You see how easy succumbs
it's
to peer pressure?
Flavor, man.
For the audio listeners, we are putting Fireball whiskey into the Sprucifer hard apple pie.
Oh, this just added a nice flavor.
I smell it. It stings the nostrils.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that was actually... I can actually palate this now.
Wow, actually,
that made it so...
Yeah! Wow, this is great! Yeah! We did it on accident! Mind link! So, that's the best shit, though, man.
Mix
all right,
this.
So...
with cinnamon.
Wow, that's actually, that's really...
This is delicious. It went from awful to amazing.
I wish I had more of this.
Oh,
I
man.
Should have gotten an 8-pack instead of 4.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Bro, man, wow. Equals... I'm a whiskey guy. It's what I do. I love the mind link, though. It's almost like I just knew. I almost got vodka, which we
oh, my God, dude. That's like...
Dangerous.
That is a dessert beverage and really easy to drink.
Fuck you, port. Coming for that ass. Apple pie beer with whiskey.
Oh my god, so good. So good. Holy shit. So Kevin, how was your week, man? So you have stories from New York, because you went to New York last weekend.
New York?
I have one good story.
Do it.
Let's do it.
So for those that have kids, you know the struggle sometimes with your kids not eating right, and then they don't poop.
Right.
So my son was having some pooping issues. He wasn't able to get it all out.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like a day and a half.
Naturally.
My wife's got the pressure on me. She's like, make sure you're giving him fiber, make sure you're giving him prunes, mm-hmm. make sure you're giving him everything. Because my wife didn't come to New York with me,
sure.
it was just me and my son. So we're on the plane, and we get to the point where you have to buckle the seatbelt at the end of the flight during the landing. And my son is in my lap. He's a lap infant. He's 2 years old, for those that don't know. Just under 2 years old.
My kids were shoulder infants.
Yeah, well, you can tell that story afterwards. Yeah. And we decided, or he decided, to stand up during the landing. And again, we're stuck in our seats. He proceeds to put one leg, one foot on each leg of mine, put his hands, one hand on each shoulder, look me in the eye, and go like this. This is during landing, so I can't get up. I can't do anything about it.
Why did he make direct eye contact with you?
I don't know, but he stared at me the whole time he did it. And it took him a good solid 3-4 minutes to get everything out. And then the plane stunk like stinky baby shit the whole way down. I got so many dirty looks getting off that plane.
What a motherfucker, dude.
So many dirty looks getting off that plane.
That's some bullshit.
So many dirty looks.
Babies poop, though.
They do.
I have never once got angry at anyone on a plane for bringing... I mean, like, they brought the baby. I assume they have a good reason. And if it does baby things, it just does baby things.
That's the logical human's excuse, but for the most part...
You got dirty looks and shit?
Oh, a ton of dirty looks. A ton of dirty looks.
Like, what are you supposed to do?
That's what I said, dude. I was like...
You're gonna push it back in?
And
yeah.
Some woman, like, purposely... You know the plane etiquette where you're getting
out of the
seat?
Oh, geez, I have to...
Yeah, she decided to, like, jump in front of me.
I have to go.
Annoying. That is some baby shit
that's
right
messed
there.
Up,
that
man.
Is some baby shit right there, yeah.
Absolutely. So, yeah, that was, can you still sell children in America?
Sometimes.
I mean, it depends, really.
Sometimes. There's a whole movie about it. It's called Taken. and if you do, Liam Neeson will kill you. And
he's
everyone
just a bad,
you hire.
Bad biker.
He's an awful. We had this conversation a few days ago.
We did. I was there for that.
Yeah. Like, if it happens once, okay. Two, man, that's bad luck. But
three times?
You need to start to question your parenting. Like
and his wife, for that matter.
Third one's his wife. Like,
so, what are you doing with the children? Right before they get kidnapped. What are you?
I don't know. Just take them to the supermarket and leave them all day? Is that... No?
So I sent my wife to Yemen to get milk.
And the kids, I just don't know.
Listen, I'm sorry to anybody who actually lives in Yemen. I heard it's awful.
Pretty bad.
I'm uncomfortable now.
Why don't you tell your poop story for your kitties?
We were at Clearwater Beach. We had just gone to Frenchie's, actually, years ago. And Haley, our oldest, wanted to sit on my shoulder. She was still in a pull-up at the time. And she, it was a water pull-up. You know, so it was already a swimmer.
Yeah.
It was little swimmers. She wanted to sit on my shoulder, so I put her on my shoulders. So she was already, like, there was salt water, and she took, like, not a normal shit, but, like a wet shit, and it was on my shoulders and ran down my back.
How long did it take you to notice?
It was very
warm water.
Quick.
Oh, you did notice
it? No, I noticed it quickly, okay. Because, yeah, that was pretty fucking gross.
That's gross.
Yeah, she shot
that's
on my
gross.
Shoulders.
Yeah. That's
so
gross.
How excited are you to have kids one day?
I'm, well, okay. I mean, I recently went to Disney World with my nephew and a newborn. I guess they're both my nephews.
Yeah.
They're both from the same set of parents that will be
so
my
they're
future
both,
they're both
therefore.
Yeah. I don't know, Phil, I needed to segregate that. But anyway, I go there, and I haven't been around kids as an adult ever,
mm-hmm.
like an infant, and I just had the most... infinite level of freaking out. Like, I was at Disney World, the happiest place in the world, like, joy on this two-year-old's face at everything, and all I was thinking was like, I'm gonna be a bad dad! Like, that's all, like, the back of my head just screaming at me, like, your kid's gonna die, because you're just gonna drop it off a building! Like, I couldn't stop myself, and I felt awful. I ruined the whole weekend because I was so psychotically entrenched in my own brain.
I mean, it'll be different when it's not yours.
That's what everyone says. Everyone says
it. Or
like,
when it is yours. Yeah.
Everyone says it's like, but when you have the kid, you pick it up and you're like, yeah, I fucking got this.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then, but before then,
yeah,
you're
you
just like.
Got this. Like changing diapers with one hand.
That's a talent.
Yeah, got it.
But when you have to do it, you have to do
you
it.
You have to do it, yeah.
And it can be done. It's yeah. not easy, but it can
it's
be done.
Scary.
I yelled at my wife today because I had to change a diaper and we were out. And she took the deodorizing bags off of the diaper bag. This is my life, guys. This is what I do when I'm not streaming. I yell at my wife for taking the deodorizing bags off of the diaper bag. Just so you know, when I hit the stop streaming button and I'm not here, that's how exciting my life is.
Was that yell-worthy, though?
Did I yell?
Did you yell?
I didn't yell. I was like,
oh, you're, okay, no, no,
it's
no,
for me.
I didn't realize this is what you were doing. Oh, you dick.
Oh, man. That's, he yelled at his wife, and he's still standing. Props. It probably, you know, like, a yell to a man, a married man, isn't really a yell. Like,
I didn't yell.
Like, a yell is like, really? That's what you're doing? Like, that's a yell. You can't, there's, that's, yeah.
It was like, what? No, babe, yeah. Seriously, where is the deodorizing bags and why that, it was at that volume. Mm-hmm. So.
That's yeah. not yelling.
No.
That's not yelling at all.
I'm trying to be more badass before Neon yeah. calls
so
me
listen!
Out. Neon, I didn't yell, okay? I didn't yell. I said it, not even sternly, I asked the question.
She's Let's, coming over tonight, right?
She'll be here, yeah. Why, are you going to try and get her up here?
I don't know. We can get the ladies up here. Did Amy decide she has to stay home with Logan?
So, I don't know.
What happened with Logan today?
Okay, this morning, we realized Logan, who's my 11-year-old lab,
right.
One of his like, thumb on his front paw was, like, all, like, jacked out. And, like, if it was a person, it would have been, like, jacked out this way and backwards. And he was just, like, walking on it, like, ow, this kind of hurts.
Did he yelp at all?
No, because he's the Terminator. If the okay. Terminator was yeah. a dog, he got bit. Okay, before we do this, he got bit by a bunch of baby snakes once. Like, 10 baby snakes who can't control their venom, okay? So, like, they'll deliver more venom than an adult snake. And he didn't fucking die. They brought him into the vet, and the vet was like, I don't know, give him Benadryl. He's pretty fucked. And then he just didn't die. Just didn't. So he's actually the Terminator. He doesn't give a shit.
Oh my god.
So he's got his jacked up backwards thumb. Amy, my fiance, she takes him into the vet, and the vet's like, oh, well, it looks like we might have to amputate, and then fucking leaves the office for like 15 minutes. Just leaves. Just says.
How do you do that?
Says.
Would you do that with people? Like, really?
It was nuts!
Like, even if that's, like, a slight chance, or a good chance, you say, hey, we're gonna look into it, I'll get right back with you. That's what you do as a compassionate human being.
That's what you got. We're taking your arm, and then just walk out of the
room. Probably gonna take that in, like, I don't know, 10, 15? It depends on how good lunch is. Like, so...
Be ready.
So she leaves, she's just sitting there, she texts me, like, they talked about amputation, I have no idea, and I get this shit while I'm streaming, and I'm like...
Oh, go, no.
Trying to play video games and not, like, weep. And then she texts me again, oh, they came back and it's fine. They're just going to rip his toenail out and then stuff it with gauze. So, like, they ripped Terminator's, you know, thumb out, and now he's fine. He's just
Is
walking.
Is he even bleeding? Like...
No! He's just walking around, like...
Just going about his
fine.
The only time he acts like anything is wrong is if our other dog gets slightly close to his paw. Logan never makes any noise, but if Pepper, like, gets just a little close, he'll be like... And I'm like, oh god, he's really mad.
I love that night I was at your house when you were describing the way Logan like goes about his life and how he acts. It's just like he's literally an old man.
Yeah,
oh, he just exists.
He just exists
as
all
a
day.
Dog.
He's an old man as a dog. Like if he could get a pipe and a smoking jacket and hang out outside all day, he would do that. And he has that look on his face
he
almost
does.
Constantly.
I can confirm. Logan like does not.
Goth get... always thinks that Logan is about to tell him something.
Yeah, like something really important. Tell me, please. Tell
yeah.
me.
Yeah, he does have that look. Like, it's like, yeah, 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 yeah.
Do you have a PlayStation yet, Kevin?
PlayStation
4.
You need one.
I think I got one.
Do you?
Yeah, I have a PlayStation.
Okay. So, but you haven't played Battleborn yet?
No.
Should do that.
Are you interested?
I'll give it a whirl.
What? Anybody on chat or YouTube or iTunes or Stitcher?
Stitcher.
Is that the other thing we're
yep.
on?
Yep.
We doing all right on Stitcher?
It doesn't really matter.
Fix it. It doesn't really matter. Wow, Android community, like, I really love the jam.
No, because
too.
You can download podcasts through podcast feeds that take from iTunes for Android. That's what I use. I don't use Stitcher.
Oh. Does anybody use Stitcher?
Like 10 people or something.
Like 10 guys?
Every week.
Yeah, it doesn't. Fuck those guys. They don't know. Anyways, Battleborn, man. Ben and I played a game of it today before the
one game.
One game. The servers gave out on us. I tried. I went back later, and the queues aren't as bad now. I feel like Gearbox actually turned on the servers.
Why did they have them off to begin with?
I spent an hour and a half playing Login Simulator. I don't know. It was great.
The best was, while you were doing that, I clicked on the Battleborn directory, and it was all the, was same, all the same picture up and down everyone waiting.
It was really fun.
I'll try it.
It's like a first-person shooter MOBA, but it has a co-op mode, and it feels like if they took raids from World of Warcraft and put them in a shooter. It's like mobs, boss fight.
MOBA doesn't appeal to me, but if it feels like Borderlands, then I would be...
The boss fights are way better than Borderlands.
Boss fights are so good. They're Gearbox so good. Learn how to do boss fights. Not like, hey, see this guy? This is health bucket 3. It's great. Yeah. Hope you have all the perfect weapons or he's going to kill you in one shot. Mm-hmm. Like, it was terrible.
It was really fun, man. I was kind of on edge about Battleborn. I enjoyed the technical test, but I hadn't played any of the co-op stuff. The co-op stuff is what's going to sell me because I can't do PvP all the time. Otherwise, I just want to fucking off myself right there. Mm-hmm. You know? But no, I really enjoyed it. And if you guys haven't tried it out, I would. It's on PlayStation it's on PlayStation now, and then next week it's the 13th?
Yeah, it's on
the 13th. I think it's the 13th.
13th everywhere else.
Yeah, and I think it goes for like another 5 days, like through next weekend or some shit. But it's really fun. I really liked it.
Did you like it?
I love it. I had a great time. It was fun. Showed a lot of potential.
A lot of people are going to look at the graphics of it and automatically discount it, I think, like people do with Borderlands, which is a shame.
This is a kid's game.
Yeah, this looks kiddy.
Fucking kids. You know what game wasn't for kids but had really shitty graphics? World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Those graphics are terrible.
They still are.
No, they're so bad. They're still really bad.
They're updating the graphics.
It's a great
game. Looks like something
it just
that's 8
goes to
old.
Show you that good games just need good mechanics. That's why people don't give a fuck what their chess pieces look like.
Right.
It's been the same way for 2,000 years.
Maybe I'll give it a try on Sunday.
I'm really looking forward to getting to the Yuengling. This is so sweet.
This is so shitty. I feel the diabetes flowing through me.
It's so sweet. It's no good.
We gotta do it, though.
I liked the first little bit of it, but...
I'm done.
I win.
You win the man race this week.
Oh, shit.
Here, you want a ying? Oh, no, you got your fireball. You're good.
I gotta finish my fireball first.
Yeah. You need that whiskey. You just drink it straight.
Ben doesn't want to make it through the night. Don't you dare insult WoW's timeless graphics. I always like the aesthetic. I like that aesthetic, though. No, sort of like comic-y or cartoony. What were we comparing it to today? What was the game?
WildStar.
Huh?
WildStar?
WildStar, yeah. It looks a lot like... It's like if WildStar was a MOBA shooter. Datto really didn't want to call it a MOBA. He was really avoiding calling it a MOBA.
I kind of like that, though, because that would make me more interested in it.
Sure. I'd wait to say that until I've played PvP.
Did you ever play Smite?
Yes, I played Smite. I played Smite on Xbox and PC.
Did you like it?
Nope.
Okay.
I thought I was going to, because it had the behind-the-back third-person view that Warcraft has, but I didn't.
WildStar crashed hard. Yeah, WildStar crashed hard, but that's because it was an MMO that was not World of Warcraft.
Right. It had its moment in the sun, and then...
Final Fantasy's doing all right, though. But I think that's because it is Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
It's the only reason Star Wars is staying afloat, too.
Because it's Star Wars?
Mm-hmm. They're like... I think they have like 700,000 subscribers still.
And we're still on the MOBA.
Yeah. And they're backed by EA, too, so...
I heard that Nocturno guy is really cool. He works at Twitch.
I heard he's really fucking cool.
I heard he just subbed too.
Yeah. We hide all the alerts during this because I know because you would just hear, "Come on, Islam, and welcome to the jam."
Yo, thank you for 3 months of subs. Yo, man, welcome to the Raptor.
This is me, Aziz. Yo, treat yourself.
Whammy. By the way, I didn't give you a hashtag for this week for questions. You can tag me, use hashtag cookie dough. If you listen to last week's episode, you'll get that. And then you can hashtag the jam and hit me up on Twitter.
People are really mad we're sharing headphones.
Are they?
Listen, man. When you're a man and you're comfortable with another man, you can share headphones.
Yeah, it's fine.
We're touching shoulders right now.
I'm sorry that you had an uncomfortable experience when you were in high school and you shared your favorite Taking Back Sunday song with your friend. And he was like, screw this, like Backstreet Boys. So sick, so sick. It'll be okay.
I mean, if two men can masturbate back to back, they can share headphones.
Absolutely.
I don't see the issue.
Nothing wrong with it. Nothing wrong. Everybody. With a little back and grind.
Oh, shit.
You want to drag someone in?
Sure, let's drag someone in.
From the Jam Lounge?
From the Jam Lounge. Let's see who we got today. I'm gonna grab Kevman. Kevman. Hey, yo, Kevman, what's up? You're on the Jam.
Oh, the first one.
Every single time.
Rip, Kevman.
Well, let's get this out of the way early. Yo, what's up, Neon? You're on the Jam.
What's up?
Yo, fucking fourth time.
At least you're ready. You're ready every time, and that's why I like you.
I'm always ready. Yo, what's up, guys?
What's up?
What's up, man?
So, for everybody who's new, where are you from? Where are you from? What's up, Neon?
Oh, shit. Okay, I'm from Ontario, Canada.
Okay, sure.
Best country ever. You know, better than the USA.
Cool. Sounds good.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
No arguments.
So, bro, man, yeah. I saw you looking at me.
I looked at you and I took a shot because you said let's do shots together. I figured you'd just figure it the fuck out.
No, Chad's we're doing
be
it now.
Real mad at you, Neon.
We're doing it now.
We're doing it now. All right.
Okay. Ready?
Three.
Awesome. Let's go.
Two. One. Boom. Okay.
Neon is a regular.
Oh.
Yeah. Every time.
Wait. What did you just take a shot of?
This like fucking Scotch whiskey shit. It's really terrible. It tastes like a boot.
All right. That's good. That's good.
So I got a question.
Sure. Go ahead.
I got a question. So, Goth, you and Broman are like peanut butter and jelly, right?
Sure.
Who's the peanut butter, who's the jelly?
Ooh.
Fucking weird question.
I like this question. And why, right, Neon?
Yeah, and why.
Yeah, okay, good.
Please write an essay, have it on my desk by Monday.
I'll do a speech. I would say that I am more like peanut butter in that I'm a little bit more basic. Perhaps you could live off of me if you want to all the time. And Goth is very sweet, and everyone loves him so much, just like jelly.
I feel like I'm more of like a strawberry jam type person, or like peach preserves, you know? Like,
oh my God.
Like, I don't like basic jelly.
I fucking
jelly.
Lied!
You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, man.
I mean, I tried my best.
I don't like jelly. I like preserves and jam.
I don't like jelly. I like preserves. All right. So I am the guy that you'll come and you'll enjoy eating and enjoy dining with me.
Yo, real question. How does Paddington the Bear not have fucking diabetes? All he eats is marmalade sandwiches. Like, real shit.
Dude, that literally
every
just
time.
Come to you right
yes.
now.
Yeah, we're talking about jammy jelly. Someone said marmalade and it reminded me of
Paddington. Marmalade, Paddington the fucking
Paddington
bear.
Paddington the fucking bear. He had all he ate was marmalade. Like all the fucking time, he's like, it's fucking. He like Winnie the Pooh should have died of diabetes too.
The question here is: do bears get diabetes?
Yo,
no.
That's a very
relevant
question.
Super,
they have to.
I think they have super insulin.
They eat honey.
They can eat whatever they want because they hibernate. They can destroy their bodies and then they fast for 9 months.
Winnie the Pooh is actually a girl.
Yes.
What?
What?
Yeah.
No.
Well, we gotta look that up.
No, Winnie. Like, yeah, no, like, the name Winnie, it's a girl. But why'd they voice it with a guy voice?
Yeah, like, I always... Like, do you think...
But did they... The better question is, did they ever say he or she in the books? I never...
Am I spelling this right?
Yes.
Winnie the Pooh, yeah.
Winnie the Pooh... No, I'm not gonna write sex.
Not sex! Gender!
Gender!
Wow, you really almost got your channel
banned. I almost...
Banned.
Male!
What?
It says male!
So man, he's a man!
Yo, I had been hearing...
I heard that same thing. Oh, wait, it's... No, the Hello Giggles article right there.
Hello, we just found out that Winnie the Pooh is actually a girl. that's why Twitch staff is here tonight. They're making sure I don't look up Winnie the Pooh sex. whatever last word you got in Hello Kitty is a fact, but I was a little human girl. You're blah, blah. Winnie is actually a female black bear. Take all the time you need to let set in, and we'll circle back whenever you're ready. We're going to want you to hear the history or story.
It's a Canadian author, by the way, Neon.
Pooh Bear News deconstructed. Canadian author.
Wait, hold up.
Yeah.
There's a website
called Pooh Bear News.
Yeah.
Is
there that much happening in the world of Winnie
this
the Pooh
is
that
some
warrants
stupid shit? Like, this
that
is
tells
dumb.
A story of
this
her
is
great
nothing.
Grandfather, Harry
this is nothing.
Is it? Well, blah, blah, blah. Followed his heart and rescued a baby bear. Colburn named the bear Winnie after his native Homepeg, Winnipeg. So, okay, listen. Okay. So I had heard that Winnie the Pooh was a female bear.
This is complete conjecture.
This is complete conjecture because they're saying that the bear that Winnie the Pooh was based on or named after was a female bear.
A female black bear named Winnie. So it's Winnie. Not actually that Winnie
it's
the
not
Pooh
actually
is
it's
a bear.
Yeah, one, this is all
one. Did that imaginary bear he rescued wear a shirt? No. Two, did that imaginary bear walk on 2 feet? No. Three, does that Winnie the Pooh look black to you?
No. Four, did Christopher Robbins ever try to fuck Winnie the Pooh?
No.
No. Awkward.
Would you have?
I hope awkward. Not.
I mean,
I'm sure if you typed Winnie the Pooh sex.
Now we know why he had such a hard time coming up with the word gender for the Google search.
Yeah.
time to go to Old Faithful.
So basically,
you guys all got Old Faithful, right?
No.
No, yeah. Oh, okay. Okay. What? Okay.
What? Like a Google? Like a,
no, and all. Oh, my God. For masturbation.
No, no, old, I know.
Everyone's
I know for
got Old Faithful.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. We were just
what,
talking
if you,
about
if you,
sex.
Like, if
it
you,
wasn't that big of a
if
jump.
If you need to masturbate without video, do you go to Google Images? Do you have, like, an Old Faithful?
Dude, no. What? Without video? Yeah, that's okay. Cool. I'll just go fuck the ground.
No, like, you. Wait. So you're telling me you can't masturbate without a moving image?
I guess not.
Huh.
It's not even been a consideration of mine.
You've never looked up a still image?
I mean, not since I
like,
was
like...
Like,
you're telling me that
not
Amy's...
since I was, like, 13.
Okay, listen. You're telling me that Amy's never been asleep and you haven't sat on the toilet and masturbated?
That's weird as shit. No, I've actually
but what,
are
you supposed
that.
To masturbate right next to her?
I already just go to like, bed!
Sometimes you gotta fucking go! If I walk upstairs...
That thought's
fucking...
never even occurred
Yo,
to me.
Here's the thing. If I walk upstairs... It's gonna make stair sounds. Sam's gonna run upstairs and catch me in my chair.
That sounds like the start of a lot of pornos.
Are you jacking off right now? Let me help. Like,
I see you're in the chair.
Okay, question. You're in the shower. Do you're gonna struggle. Masturbate. Is it shampoo or conditioner?
Conditioner.
Conditioner. It's a yeah. Fucking weird question.
It's made for that.
What? It's hard times, man.
Ooh. Okay.
Where the fuck do you guys masturbate?
We just got a lot of
Joe,
people
is there,
in trouble
is
at
a
work.
For, is there a for the shower masturbate gel?
Absolutely. There's an everything.
I tell you,
dare Google you to Google
it,
that one
Google
right
it,
now.
But don't do it on the, like, hide the window before you Google it.
Okay. We're going to hide the window, then we're going to Google that.
You guys, okay, since we're on the subject, you guys see the picture of a dude's mom that took a picture of his bathroom with a fucking fleshlight stuck to the wall?
No.
And posted it on Facebook and was like, Timmy's got this in his room and for in his shower. Does anyone know what the hell this is?
Fucking legit.
It was stuck to the
wall. It was like suction cup to the wall.
Like waist high?
Yeah. For shower dicking.
Is there actually a...
Yeah, people like I saw that. That's what's up.
You don't use shower jerk-off gel is not what you want to Google to find
Well,
that.
What would you Google?
Use masturbation shower gel.
Master...
I promise I haven't done this before.
Shower gel. It's the same results
it is the
as
same
what I put in.
Oh, but there's an IGN guide to it.
There's a...
What?
This is an IGN. Oh, it's a message board. This is a fucked up article. It's got parts.
It's a full guide.
This is a really in-depth
guide. That is a lot of details.
Hold on.
Flooding is a technique I developed when I placed a washcloth over the drain in my stand-up shower. Oh. After about 5 minutes, the water level rises to about 3 inches, and this can be used as an ample net for your semen.
I just read that! Why? It's right there!
What?
Where do people find time to do this shit? Stay away from shampoo in big capital letters. Did you guys catch that?
Well, here's the thing about shampoo.
It gets in the pee hole.
Shampoo and it has burns. A lot of alcohol in it. Okay.
It does?
Yeah, a lot of shampoos. Yeah, a lot of... you didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
A lot of cheaper shampoos use a lot of alcohol which actually dries out your hair a lot. So if that gets in your pee hole, it's gonna get irritated.
Yeah.
Where conditioner does not.
Random story.
It's moisturizing.
Random story.
Yeah.
Scared. When I was in the band and I was going on tour back in the day.
Sure.
I'm a hairy guy, so
right.
I gotta shave the chest. I forgot to before I left. So the first stop, I think we were in Connecticut or somewhere. By the way, Neon's still going. Hey, Neon.
Hi, Neon.
Yo, what's up, Neon? Yo, Neon, thanks for being on the jam, dude.
So I forgot to shave my chest. So the first stop, I don't know where we were, I bought Nair.
Right. Oh, that's dumb. I had a hairy friend in high school. That's dumb.
I didn't know you can't put Nair on your nipples.
Yeah. What? Why can't you put Nair on your nipples?
Because it rips the fucking skin off your nipples. And then for 3 weeks, every time you wear a shirt or rub up on anything, it hurts a lot.
You guys ever get your nipples sunburnt?
No.
That shit hurts like hell and they turn green.
Green?
Green! No. My nipples straight up turned green, son. Green.
No. That ain't right.
Like I was an alien. I thought I had skin cancer. I was one day away from going to the doctor and then they started to peel, which was also a really weird experience.
Green?
Green, son.
Like, you're talking like green like the green screen, green even like though they can't see.
Green like I wish I could hold up a color. Yeah.
Oh my god.
It was gross.
That's terrifying, no?
It was gross.
To like see your nipples and they're green.
Yeah.
Were you afraid that they were going to go away?
like fall off? No, yeah. I wasn't afraid they were going to fall
like
off.
Like gangrene.
That makes sense.
That's totally different.
I follow the logic.
I don't.
That ain't right. That ain't right. I'm looking it up.
Do not show pictures of nipples.
You can't show pictures of nipples.
You cannot show
pictures. You used to be able to show your nipples on Twitch.tv.
I used to not wear a shirt on my stream all the time.
You have Twitch chat in or Twitch staff in your chat, and you're about to put nipples all over.
Well, I just want to, like, true or false, do sunburnt nipples turn green?
All right, hang on.
All right. You're going to do it?
Fucking phone it up. Phone it up, dude.
We'll find out.
That's going to fall.
Listen, yeah, I want to ruin everything about your room right now. okay, all right. Do sunburnt nipples turn green? All right, let's see what this says. Why did it go to Please that? Help sunburn nipples, first of all.
What?
I Twitter defaulted to.
Why is it on Asian? Why does your phone?
Yo, your Twitter's on Asian date. What the fuck?
Fucking Kevin's Twitter is
on Asian date.
Constantly connect instantly with gorgeous Asian women using Asian date chat ASAP. Have you ever dated an Asian woman?
For like 2 days.
That was my one regret in life, is I never dated an Asian woman. That's it.
I found Asian women very attractive.
Same. That's because we're white men.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is. I didn't have a beard when I here's what I found out is that Asian women primarily like white men with beards that are slightly overweight.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Yeah. But I was really skinny and had no beard. I thought we could, like, train Tamagotchis together. Like, when I tell you that I wanted to date an Asian woman, I didn't want to date, like, an Americanized Asian woman. I wanted to date, like, a would kick my ass at Super Mario anything, train Tamagotchis together, battle Pokemon Asian woman. What?
What does that woman look like to you?
She would, like,
pink hair. Why? Don't go further down the rabbit
hole. No, man, he's very open.
Like,
I know that.
He said, I don't know, like, pink hair. Hair doesn't...
like Animu.
Like an Animu lady. All right.
I can't.
Goth wanted to date an anime chick.
That's not even right.
Was it Bulma, Goth? Did you want to date Bulma?
It might have been Bulma. Yeah.
Yo, 600 pounds, hairy, thunder thighs, and 6 dangling Tamagotchi.
Like an anime.
Holy shit.
It's not racist at all, dude. There's, like, come on. You can say whatever you want, but, like, NASCAR-loving...
Yeah, man.
...southern white guy. And I'm gonna be like, yeah, there's white people like that. Now, when I say there's probably some Asian chicks out there who train Tamagotchis and are really good at Super Smash Brothers...
That's accurate.
Right.
Now you're racist.
It's the same thing like every black guy loves Dragon Ball Z.
Super racist.
That's not even racist! Every single one of my black friends loves Dragon Ball Z.
Okay, those are two different statements. You said every black guy... Did he say that first?
Yes.
Okay.
You know what? I'm going to say every black guy loves Dragon Ball Z. Yo, everyone in chat right now... True, but semantics. Listen, every single one of you in chat right now is black and loves Dragon Ball Z. I told you! I'm telling you! Everybody in chat right now and on YouTube and iTunes, if you have a black friend, does he like Dragon Ball Z? Regardless of the fact that he's a nerd or not.
It's a poll.
Straw poll?
Okay,
don't straw poll that.
I'm not gonna straw poll that? Fine. Fine, I won't straw poll that.
I don't like Dragon Ball Z, I just like regular Dragon Ball.
Listen, when Goku got grown up, I was
fucking done with that shit.
I liked Goku better when he was patting Bulma's coochie. You ever see that shit?
Yes! It's messed up. Also a thing I'm pretty sure that you went to
I
Google.
I cannot Google that because someone has probably made some homemade hentai.
I got an interesting tweet from Happy Mallard. He said, "Did you hear about the JCPenney Hitler tea kettle incident?"
No.
Nope. Let's look it up.
Very interesting.
JCPenney
Hitler tea. There it is. Teapot eBay.
Teapot eBay.
Oh my God! What is this? JCPenney tea. Where is it? What am I looking at?
Go back.
Is there an article? Michael Graves whistling.
Oh, there it is on The Guardian under the pictures.
Right here?
Under the pictures. Down one. Yep.
Okay. J.C. Penner's Hitler tea kettle sells out but finds a new home on eBay.
Oh, I get it. Look at the fucking handle.
Oh,
yeah. I didn't get it. Now I get it. I don't know. It looks like
Figures that out.
That looks like fucking clown Hitler.
I mean, no, yeah, that's
that looks like clown Hitler. If that knob was red,
I was expecting more.
Did I ever tell you? About
it would be like Mein Kampf. Like it would not even be a. It would be a joke.
Did I ever tell you about when I worked at the restaurant at Ale House? There was an old guy and his wife who would always come in, and he would only refer to her in clown names.
That's fucking. What
he treated her. Like garbage, and I was always mad about this. But he always called her like Buzzo. Yeah, it was fucking insane, dude.
And that's in public. Think what goes on behind closed doors. That's scary.
How long do you think she'd been putting up with that?
I don't know.
Too long. How do you guys feel about clowns?
I wish I would have said something.
I got a story about clowns.
Yeah.
All right. So. The only time I ever got detention when I was in high school was when I got detention from my study hall teacher, because we're supposed to be quiet in study hall, but sure. Me and my friend, we'd always get online and look up clown websites, like personal websites for people who were clowns.
Oh,
this was back like 5 years after the internet launched, and every single one of them looked like the website for a guy who was going to murder you.
Like
no matter how hard they tried,
they
were like, "Hi, I'm Shano, and I'm a clown, and I like whatever." Like, whatever you got, babies dead in your basement. It was awesome. So we would do that all day, every day, and I couldn't stop laughing because you know when you're not supposed to laugh is when you laugh the most.
Of course.
Hey, be quiet. Yeah, every time. Every fucking time.
But how do you feel about clowns?
They terrify me.
Why do clowns terrify you?
Because of what I just said. Clown I meet looks like they're going to kill me and take my intestines and then, like, cook a dinner with it or make a balloon animal. I don't know what they're going to do because they're fucking clowns. And they're crazy. And they went to college for that shit. And they don't teach you how to be a clown at clown college. They teach you how to fucking kill people.
Okay, I agree with that. I saw it when I was 6.
Is your wife coming over? My wife just texted me.
I don't think so.
Like 3 minutes ago, 4 minutes ago.
Want me to call her?
I mean, yeah, let's do it.
All right, hold on.
Or you can text her, whatever.
Text works, actually.
Baby!
That's not, that's goth, that's a goth text.
Yeah. She's supposed to. Babe, if you're watching, she's supposed to. Amy's downstairs. So, you know. Pennywise the Clown. Who's Pennywise the Clown?
The guy from It.
Oh.
Yeah, he haunts me.
I never saw It. Maybe that's why I'm not afraid of clowns.
You never saw that? I mean, that could be part of it.
Yeah, I've never seen it. Is that an animu?
Was It an animu? No, it was not.
I'm sure there's an anime version of it now.
Nope. She's not answering. She's done with me.
You ever, whenever she doesn't pick up, do you ever worry?
Yeah.
And she was in a terrible car accident?
Are you worried about it now?
That's how I always feel. Like, whenever I can't get a hold of Sam, I'm always worried that, like, someone got in the house, you know?
Yep.
That's the first place
that's
my...
It.
That's it. Like, someone got in the house, or, like...
Everybody's dead.
Or, like, her and the kids, like a fucking, like, Godzilla showed up, or, like, you know, Dragon Zord came out of the lake.
Don't you think...
Stepped on your house.
Yeah.
Because it was busy going to fight something else.
Yeah.
And didn't care about your house. No, I'm right there
with you. I'm always worried about that shit.
The second I call... It's even worse with my parents. Like, if I call my parents to try and talk, and they don't pick up the phone, I'm like, shit, they fell down and they didn't have life alert.
Like, what if...
Fucking
like my,
over.
My wife is... she's really clumsy. And whenever
he's
I'm out of
wrong.
Town...
He's telling the truth. He's telling the truth.
She's really clumsy for having such great balance. And whenever I'm not home and I can't get a hold of her, I'm worried that she, like, slipped and fell in the shower and like, hit her head real hard and the kids are going to find her or something. And the kids don't know my phone number.
The kids don't know your phone number?
No, it's in their... They both have phones, but their phones are dead because they don't know how to fucking plug them in. Now I'm paying money every month.
That is a part of parenting that I didn't think about until right now.
Yeah.
I'm going to drill my kids.
About numbers?
So they
know
my fucking phone number.
My daughter
So they
knows.
Know how to call daddy if mommy fell down the steps and isn't moving.
They know to call 911.
No, my daughter knows my phone number by heart. And
good.
Yeah, no.
Good.
My kids are fucking, they're dumbasses sometimes. Like, just straight up, they're kind of derpy as fuck.
Awesome.
I got another good Twitter question.
I'm archiving this shit for someone's 16th birthday. It's gonna be great.
Yeah. Yeah. That's called paranoia. I don't know, dude. I didn't feel like that way about, well, I don't feel that way about anything else.
I don't think that's paranoia.
Like, I don't even know Sam's schedule. It's only when I'm out of town that I feel like that, because I feel like shit hits the fan when you go out of town.
Yeah.
It does.
Jay Lukey on Twitter wants to know, if you had to live with any streamer, who would it be?
Like me?
All of us.
I don't know, man. I think Goth and I would live together pretty good. I used to live with Whitwick, so that was great.
Like peanut butter and jelly?
Oh, my God.
What's
any streamer?
Like this is a situation. Why am I not living with my family? Or am I single?
I keep telling you, once they tweet the question, we can't create a hypothetical situation. You have to
based
on the tweet.
Yeah, but I need to know in what reality.
So create the scenario yourself and give reasons why. I already know mine. It's my buddy Chef Wayne Faze, because he's an amazing chef and he would make a great house husband.
I don't know, dude.
What, are we now implying the person we're living with can't stream anymore? Then it's definitely God. That's what you wanted to hear, isn't it, Internet?
Oh my God.
No, man, I probably live with T-Rex if I had to pick somebody. He's my brother, I don't know. Easy answer.
That is an easy answer.
That's a really easy answer.
That's an easy answer. I'm lucky as shit. What about
you? I don't know, man. I don't know, probably soda popping, because now we're best friends.
Now you're best friends! I'd live with Angry Joe then. Yeah, we are new best friends. New best friends!
Oh, man. Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. For those of you who weren't privy to the information, I met Chance while we were at...
Oh, look, they're on first-name terms now. Not even screen names anymore.
I met Chance when we were in San Francisco this week, and fucking we'd...
Chance is soda popping, by the way.
Soda popping.
Soda popping.
Yeah, I didn't like, honestly, I didn't know what to expect with him. I didn't know what he was going to be like in person.
Sounds like a blind date.
I didn't know either.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I mean, you meet these people, like, when you go on to do, like, big events with Twitch, there's all these people there, and you're like, oh, shit, that guy's going to be there? Fucking hope they're cool.
Yeah.
Or
you
like,
you never know.
Yeah, you don't know, man.
You never know.
Good meet. You never know. Like, I'm still, you know, the cool thing that's never happened to me on Twitch is I've never met anyone that streams on Twitch that was a complete jackass. Like, I'm still waiting for the day where I show up to an event and I'm like, hope everyone's cool. And then one guy shows up and you're like, you're that celebrity that gets mad at people, aren't you? You know, like, this is the guy that, like, grabs a bag of M&Ms and is like, there's greens in here, fuck you! And, like, just throws it at the production manager.
Who do you think that would be?
I don't know, man.
Why not Datto? I don't know, man. I don't know, dude. I don't know. I don't think Datto and I would be great roommates. I don't know. I love Datto just fine.
He's really quiet. I don't know.
Yeah, I've... You know, okay, so, like, Datto...
He's not that quiet. He was pretty fun.
Yeah, he was pretty fun at DestinyCon.
Yeah, he was...
I don't know, man. I guess I don't know. I'd have to hang out with Datto.
Everyone thinks Chariona would be the guy freaking out about the M&Ms. I don't know, man. Probably.
I don't know, man. I feel like I would yell too much for Datto to get his YouTube videos done.
Oh, he'd be yeah. come into your room with an axe in the middle of the night and kill you.
Listen.
You need to stop it. the gold approach. Absolutely.
Gold.
He's not a streamer anymore.
I don't know, man.
TOS is a son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch. Follow the rules. Son of a bitch. Just be nice. It's like a goddamn playground.
Holy shit.
Ironforge Gaming said you wanted to talk about aliens for some reason.
Do you believe in aliens?
I believe in the possibility of life on other planets.
Do you think that there is life on another planet currently?
Define life. There absolutely has to be. Life could be something as small as plant life.
Do you think in your mind that there is intelligent life?
That's a different story. I have no idea.
Yes.
I don't know.
I believe that there is.
It's a statistical necessity.
I feel like they're statistically... I feel like...
If we're talking about the entire universe...
Yeah.
The fact that we exist necessitates that somewhere among the billions and trillions of stars, there is at least one other intelligent species. Whether or not we're ever able to communicate or reach each other...
Like, statistically, I don't feel like it's possible for there not to be intelligent life elsewhere.
Yeah. Nah. Is there intelligent life on this stream?
No,
definitely not. I just don't know. I take the... I have no idea. But you're a professor, you know.
I'm a professor of nothing.
Facts.
The jam.
But, I could say, again, life... You said intelligent life, but plant life, cellular life? Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Absolutely, without a doubt. Intelligent life? I don't know. Who knows? I'd love to meet them if they're out there. If it doesn't end up like Independence Day, Alien, what are some other
probably all staying away. They're all staying away from us.
Prometheus.
They see shit like this out there.
Can you crunch some numbers for us? I could.
That's Datto's job. His roommate.
You gotta.
This is a one.
I'm trying to crunch it. I can't. It's too plastic.
Got liquid in it.
We're losing him.
We are losing him. Too much fireball. Let's pull someone random.
Good things Amy's here.
Yo, Shinyan, what's going on? You're on the jam.
Hello.
How you doing?
What's up?
Not too bad. How are you guys doing?
Where are you from? That's a neat accent.
I'm from Ireland.
Oh!
Nice. It's a sweet
it's
accent.
It's just cool when people from other countries call.
It is cool.
Except Canada.
You're up really late. It's late there.
I knew the jam was coming on, so I got a few beers in, and I wanted to stick around and hopefully have a chat with you guys. And here I am.
Here you are.
Fuck, your voice is charming.
It is
very charming. I wish I had an Irish accent, dude.
You can have one whenever you want to.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Shoot.
Guy with Irish accent whose name I can't see on the screen. I'm sorry, I missed it.
Shinyan.
How do you say it?
Shinyan.
Okay, so ladies here really like Irish accents. Do ladies in Ireland like American accents, or do they think we all sound stupid?
I don't know.
The answer is yes. We're all stupid.
Yeah, I mean, I guess.
Yeah, I don't think there's any woman around the world who's like, you know what I really like?
American
guys. Have you seen Joe Dirt? Really?
Is that really the perception you have of us, though?
No.
Yes. Another yes.
Wow. Well,
would I stay up this late drinking beers just to watch you guys because you're from America? No, because you're cool guys. It doesn't matter where you're from.
Okay. So he wants to watch a bunch of rednecks hang out on the talk
show. Here's your sign. Get her done.
Oh, man, I can't believe I'm talking to you guys right now. This is crazy.
Do you have any questions for us?
Yeah, do you have any questions? Like, I stole your question time. Sorry.
I don't suppose I have any questions, but I just want to say that I've been watching your guys' streams, Broman and Got, like since basically day one of Destiny, and super amazing, super cool guys.
Oh, thanks, man.
And yeah, just want to tell you to keep it up, keep it going. My heart is beating now because I can't believe I'm talking to you guys. It's crazy.
Well, it's been a pleasure, man. Yeah, thank you for watching, and thank you for the nice comments.
Yeah, no worries, man. Keep it up, guys.
Yeah, fuck you, Kevin.
Fuck you, Kevin. Get out. Welcome to the jam with Broman and God.
Yo, Kevin.
No, Kevin got encoding on his own the other night.
He last did. Night. Last night.
Last
night.
It's
a big deal. NHL.
NHL? Really?
Yep.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah. A lot of the nice people from here have been hanging out a lot, so I got
that's cool, man. Help last night. We gotta get Kevin partnered. We have to get K Magic 101 partnered, Twitch.
On Twitch.
On Twitch.
Yo, on Twitch!
There's so many people in here that really just want to see Kevin.
It's crazy!
Okay,
Yo, it's crazy!
I also joined,
I don't need a voice changer for
I'm
that
on a
shit.
Twitch team now too.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm on Spazzy's The Family.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that happened. I saw my BFF is in chat tonight. What's up, Wish? How you doing, buddy?
Oh, is Wish here? Did he tell you fuck the Mets yet?
No, he said hi, Kevin. That's it. I'm waiting for the rest
so
of it.
So nice.
I'm waiting for the rest of it.
He's gonna get you, Mets. Dude. He always thinks you're, you know.
We go in each other's channels now. We say hello. It's good. Maybe we'll take in a baseball game later in the year, me and Wish.
Kevin, you want to talk about the hockey game that I went to with you?
I didn't get to go to that.
What about
talk
how about miserable
that?
I
do
was?
You talk about, do you want to talk about how personally tortured I was the entire time? Okay, so the Lightning, which is the Tampa Bay hockey team, every time they score a fucking goal point in the hockey puck game... There's fucking Tesla generators all around the fucking stadium that do Tesla lightning shit.
It's pretty awesome.
And so every time I start to get to see lightning, and I'm like, fucking, this is awesome. I look over and I see Kevin, and Kevin's like,
well, you have to preface,
fucking murder a cat.
They were playing against the Islanders, playoff implications, so that's why. Any other time, I'd be super awesome.
Did the Lightning make it to the playoffs?
Lightning in the playoffs, but they got like three of their major players injured. So
yeah, including
Stamkos.
Yeah, Stamkos.
Yep.
Yeah, they're done.
Yeah, no, they're done. So are the Islanders, so it's all good.
Are they? Can the Islanders?
No, they lost like three of their players.
No, they're totally boned. That's why Kevin was getting so mad. It was great.
Yeah. Hold on, what did Wish say? I went to a Mets game the other day. No, you didn't. Saw the people behind the plate with pistols in their mouths. What's that about, Kevin? Wish, we know that's not true, because you would never go to a Mets game.
That's true. That's really true.
Ever.
Yeah.
Ever. Is Wish coming to Destiny Community Con?
Better.
I think so.
I'm putting him on the spot right now. I really want him to be there. I want everyone to be there. Oh, can you... Even though we don't talk about Destiny Community Con on here, can you say the thing again just so...
For those of you who did not know, tomorrow, April 9th, at noon Eastern...
Saturday.
That's got to go away.
Yeah, it really does.
The Destiny Community Con exotic VIP t-shirt will be going back on sale up to 100 units... And that's it. That is it. That's it.
What was the time again?
Noon Eastern.
It will be gone in less than 20 minutes.
Less than 10 minutes.
I think it'll take an hour.
I think you always underestimate everything.
Wait, how long did it take to sell 300 shirts, Ben? An hour and a half, right?
An hour and a half.
How many were we selling this time?
So we're selling 100.
Oh, okay.
Statistics would indicate... With basic simple math, that it was 30 minutes. It would
and
be
that's
30 judging, minutes.
That's a soda pop and emote? How did he get... How is it that big?
Oh, there's another one. I think it's a glitch. There was another one. This guy came on my stream with a sniped emote. It said sniped, and it was like the whole chat had a crosshair on it. Like the guy blew chat up with his sniped emote.
If you can't get the exotic shirt, you can always buy mine when it goes on sale again.
It gets you nothing.
Gets you absolutely nothing.
Except Ben kicks you in the ass.
Oh, yeah, I know. The exotic at perk Destiny of anyone Community. Wearing Kevin's shirt at Destiny Unicon is I will kick you and not hug you.
Literally. Literally.
And I will get Goth to do it, too, even though he doesn't want to.
Uh-oh.
Is that it?
I think that was it, yeah.
Just making sure.
Shouldn't you know your best friend's emotes on Twitch? I'm just saying.
Why didn't it do
Whoa!
It? Why didn't it do it?
That's why I think email. No, it showed up over there, dude. It showed up on that.
And it was big
up
on that one?
Yeah, it showed up on the OBS overlay. Interesting.
That's so weird.
That's jacked up, man.
Does, oh my God. Does anybody need to take a break? Because I think we're at the one-hour mark.
Sure. Guys, we're going to take about a three-minute break and run some ads. I'll be right back, and then we'll be back with the B-side of The Jam. Thank you for hanging out, and we'll be right back.
Sweet.
Well, fucking no. I'm going to hit this button for commercials to happen. Do that. See you in a few, guys. All right, guys, we're back with
The Jam.
I don't know why.
Jam.
I got a tweet from The Drew Show. Rogue One trailer. Came out yesterday.
Sure. We can't show it for copyright reasons.
Yeah. Plus, the audio listeners don't want to listen to a movie trailer.
No.
So, what was your original thoughts, Corey, when you watched it?
I'm hyped for it. I mean, like, Disney's definitely going with, like, lady power for it, which is good.
I don't even care about that. Like, okay. Whatever. If the as long as they're not forcing the issue of using certain sexes, mm-hmm. genders.
Yeah. I was hoping to see, a young Leia in it.
No, I mean,
it's only,
like...
It's only a year before, so how could they do that?
When I say forcing the issue, I mean in the sense that, like...
Forcing the issue.
Here's a woman, and we're putting her here because... No, if it's just, like, here's the hero, and she happens to be a woman, cool. Like, with Rey. Ray was amazing.
Yeah, made sense.
True. Amazing.
Sure.
Very true.
But like
a lot of questions unanswered though with Ray.
Good.
Very.
I like that.
Yeah.
I'm all about that.
Yeah.
But no, the Rogue One trailer, I thought, first of all, Mon Mothma. She's got to be like in her 90s if she's still alive.
Looks exactly the same.
How?
I don't know.
How? Magic.
Yeah, I don't know.
Magic.
Space magic?
Space magic.
I don't think... It's not the same actress, is it?
It can't be.
It can't be.
It literally can't be.
So they found a doppelganger?
It has to be.
Either did that or they did perfect CG. I mean,
it
they
could
did
be.
Weird
I mean, did
CG
you see Hunger
shit.
Games, the third one? With,
that's
yeah.
true, yeah, with... what's his face? Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yeah, there we go. Thank God somebody thought of it. I've had some... I've
been, oh, that was about to be...
That would have been real awkward.
Just Philip Seymour Hoffman.
yes, this is before episode four. Yeah, it's the beginning. It's the beginning for a new trilogy. It's not the beginning for a new trilogy.
No, no, no. These are the...
It's a gap year film.
It's a gap yeah. year. Yeah, it's like...
they tell another story from the same universe.
Yes.
That will be a standalone, mm-hmm. but still informs
yeah,
the other story.
It's the...
It's the story of how the plans for the Death Star get
stolen. The same
stolen.
Actress? Shut up. It's a different actress. I don't
how
know.
Is it
and,
the same actress?
And I think Darth Vader's going to be in it.
The breathing at the end would
totally
indicate
I hope
indicate
so,
that.
Man. I want to see like a ruthless...
I want to see the in-between Darth Vader.
Killing
like,
motherfucker. But it's like a year, so it's like, how different could he be?
I mean, I've changed a lot in a year.
Sure.
Right? So like maybe Darth Vader went from like... gutting everyone in the universe to maybe only choking someone a little bit
same
because they weren't
from episode
doing
three
things
for
as fast.
She wasn't know, in man. Episode three. She's in episode four, I think.
I don't know.
She's not in episode three.
I hope they make a Shadows of the Empire movie.
I hope so, too. I hope they make a movie about Revan.
What a fucking great Nintendo 64 game that
yes.
I remember.
That was a good game.
It was
a
good game, dude. Yeah,
that was a really good game.
I really... Shadows of the Empire was dope. You got to like fucking fly around in the asteroid field and be on Hoth and
somebody said Boba Fett's going to be in it. How would we know that yet? They cast
Boba Fetters.
Well, they're doing a Boba Fett movie, aren't they?
Supposedly there's a Boba this is what I've heard rumors of. None of this is confirmed.
Sure.
The one I affectionately call When Han Met Chewie. Mm-hmm. Supposedly Obi-Wan's backstory. Which I kind of don't
backstory
want.
Meaning what?
Like, I guess how he became a Jedi and everything.
So they're going to go back to where the Jedi Order is about, like...
Oh, it'll be before episode one.
I'm really interested in that. Because okay. I like seeing when the Jedi Academy is active and... You know what I don't get? Here's the thing. How much time is there in between episodes three and four?
Three and four is not many years.
It's not... It can't be many.
Someone said Mon Mothma's in the deleted scenes in
how old is Luke? So it's maybe like 15 years?
15 between 4 and 5? 3 and 4?
3 and 4.
Luke's born?
I mean, he's like 20 in that one.
19 years.
I think he's still a teenager.
Let's say 19 years.
Fair assessment.
Like, all of the Imperial, like, uppers, like, treat Darth Vader like his religion is ancient. You know, like, you're clinging on to that ancient religion.
But what you gotta remember, 19 years, 18 years, 20
yeah.
years, we're around the right place.
Okay.
When you wipe out the Jedi Order, there's only two Sith. So you're really wiping out that whole sort of Force user situation in
so
general.
So no one remembers it?
Not that they don't remember it, but they... At 20 years later, like, would you still think something was true or real?
Let me ask you a question.
They treat it like it's
let
fake.
Let me ask you a question. What do you feel like when you talk to people who are 20 years younger than you about ways that you used to communicate
okay.
before the internet?
That's fair.
They'd be like, you actually...
But they're not younger. They're just as old as Vader.
Well, I'm just saying, 20 years changes things pretty rapidly, so the whole idea of being a Jedi to them could be just as dumb as me using a phone instead of fucking texting somebody or sending a letter instead of an email.
Yo, if I talk to you right now about Power Rangers, you gonna remember everything about Power Rangers?
Different man.
It's not different.
You're not living in the world. You're sociologically ignoring how it could exist.
You're also taking something that you liked and you were very much into when you say Power Rangers. The Force is not something
that's
that
definitely
everyone,
not something
was
everyone was into.
Right. Just saying.
Yo, you remember Blue's Clues? I didn't care for Blue's Clues.
Then why is Steve in the intro to your stream?
Because he's funny dancer.
Oh yeah.
Did he get in trouble for like child porn or
anything? No, it's not child porn, dude.
I feel Blues, like he got in trouble.
The galaxy is a big place. Sure, but like, okay, Obi-Wan Kenobi shows up at the planet where he rides the fucking big-ass iguana. Motherfucker's there. No, he's a Jedi when he gets there by
by the way he's dressed.
Which planet? What are you talking about?
The way he, where he goes.
The one
to
where
fight.
He shows up with a giant lizard and everyone's really tall and weird.
Yeah, the tall guys with the teeth, and that's where he fights fucking robot man.
You don't know whether or not those people are mind readers.
The noise that that thing makes that he rides. It's the weirdest thing. The weirdest thing.
Those motherfuckers knew.
Utapu, thank you.
Yeah, those dudes knew that he was a Jedi, okay? I'm just saying.
But they were also part of the Republic.
I'm just...
Not all of space is part of the Republic. That's the whole point.
Republic. I'm just saying.
There's the Outer Rim, which is where Tatooine is, which doesn't answer to the Republic. Just saying. Just throwing it out there.
I just feel like not everybody would... whatever. I'll back off from that. So returning to subject.
Yeah. Rogue One.
I feel like I hope that Darth Vader's in it. I want to see a
would they
a slightly
really
under-
would they really cock tease you with the breathing at the end if Darth Vader's not in it?
I don't know.
We had the discussion of Darth Vader not being in it if James Earl Jones was dead, but he's
alive.
Not dead.
He's very much alive.
So yeah, I just think that Vader has to be in it. If he had passed away, I think there would be a high chance of Vader not being in the movie.
No, he's alive.
But since he's around, yeah. I think he's down to clown.
I think even if he died, they could still get a shot of Vader, like, doing something that didn't require talking.
It's possible.
But we don't have to have this discussion.
He could just be mute. They could do that stupid whole, like,
his voice box got destroyed.
But he yelled no at the end of the third movie,
no,
and it's a big
no.
meme.
Yeah, he blew his voice box out. They couldn't replace it.
The time period of Rogue One is
Disney.
Before Episode 4, right before
Is it 1 year before Episode 4?
I don't know the timing exactly, but it's right before Episode 4.
I mean,
they
get the preview showed them putting the dish for the laser.
Right.
The Death Star essentially uses, like, Jedi technology, like lightsaber technology for the laser, don't they?
That's the vibe I get from it.
Yeah.
I don't know if they ever explain that.
Yeah.
Maybe in the comics.
I hope they explain it.
But that's all retconned anyway.
Yeah.
Thanks, Disney.
That was something Disney didn't have to do when they bought the rights.
James Earl Jones is doing the voice for Vader in Star Wars Rebels right now.
He's also doing the voice of Mufasa in The Lion Guard on Disney Junior. So
what is The Lion Guard?
The Lion Guard...
It's Simba's son, right?
Yeah. It's really stupid.
So why is Mufasa in it?
Because Mufasa comes back as this big awesome ghost thing that he does in the movie. But they completely cheapen it for the little kids. So he's just like Cloud Mufasa in the sky, but he's not even a cloud. He's in color. He always comes back. He's like, Kion! I hate it. And then in the show...
What does he tell him to do? Like, teach him how to clean a room?
It's just like, you know, you have to be brave for the other animals, because you are the leader of the Lion Guard. It's so dumb.
Is it your typical Disney show that always tries to teach you how to not be a fucker every episode? Because that's what Disney cartoons are now. It's like Special Agent Oso. Oh, so he's like, God. I gotta go teach the kid how to clean his room. And like the kid's like, I don't know. I shit on it.
I'll put this out there. My buddy Pete and I were talking. We both have sons that are 2 weeks apart, so okay. We were talking about Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. For those of you out there that have kids, you know that Mickey Mouse Clubhouse, no matter how much you love Disney, is the most mind-numbing, insane shit you'll ever watch in your life.
Yo, why are they friends with Pete the Cat? That dude used to smoke cigars and try to kill Mickey
because
and Donald.
Because on Mickey it's Mouse true. Clubhouse, everybody's friends!
Like, that's fucked up.
What happened? Like, okay, and
we're gonna go to Mickey Park and solve the mystery! But wait. They have this thing called Toodles that comes out.
Ah!
Hold on.
What the fuck's the Toodles?
So
that's what you say when you really want to say goodbye and you want to never talk to that person again. Toodles.
Like, so they're like, oh, look at the cat's stumping. Yep, he knows. The cat's stuck up in the tree. Whatever are we going to do?
You got to find Toodles.
Let's call Toodles. Oh, Toodles. And it goes, bah, 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 bah. And this little circle thing with Mickey Mouse ears comes out. And it's like, has all these different tools that they can use to get the fucking cat out of the tree. And whatever the tool
is. Do you want to use a shotgun?
They're like, which tool is going to be best for us to use here, kids? And then they pause so the children has time to process it.
Oh my God, I hate the pause.
And there's four things. There's four things on there. Whatever you think is probably the most logical tool to use in the situation to get the damn cat out of the tree, you're wrong. They're like, you guessed it. We're using the Band-Aid. And why would you use a Band-Aid
Wait,
to
so
get a cat
it doesn't,
out of the tree?
It doesn't actually, it's always ridiculous?
No. They're like, we're going to hang the Band-Aid from the tree branch, and we're going to let the cat fall into the Band-Aid, and then we're going to take the Band-Aid and pull the cat down out of the tree. That doesn't make any sense!
No,
Kevin, it really doesn't. I'm terrified that children in 20 years...
long enough to forget about the Force.
I hate that.
Would be really concerned and do silly shit like try and help people jump off buildings with a Band-Aid. I feel like Disney is falling short in teaching a generation how to, you know, just
I agree with you. I like PJ Masks.
I have an issue
PJ
with
Masks.
There's no
show.
Villains anymore in Disney shows.
No, because they don't want anyone to see, like, oh, yeah, no, it's bad. We're all friends. Everything's good.
It's fucked up. Even Jake and the Neverland Pirates.
Nope.
He's just wacky. You know, he's like...
he's just silly. We're going to help him solve the treasure problem. But then we're going to take the treasure so we have all the gold doubloons at the episode. How many gold doubloons did we steal from Captain Hook today?
Yes, I said steal because at the end of every episode, Jake ends up with the gold, not Captain Hook. So
Jake
who's the real villain there? Yeah.
Back in my day, Captain Hook was always trying to gut Peter Pan.
Right? And beat him to
murder
a crocodile.
Him. Yeah.
Or the crazy mermaids.
Yeah.
Because in the real story, the mermaids are...
are they?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they're messed up. I do love...
well, I mean, mermaids used, like... I mean, like, they used to eat sailors. Like, that was the big
trick. Those are sirens, aren't they?
Similar. They're, like, one in the same in Pirates of the Caribbean, is what you're thinking of.
I always liked the dead mermaid on the Pirates ride at Disney World.
I love the Pirates ride.
Yo,
it's so
you know what
weird.
I haven't seen in so long is the little light in the water with the little mermaid swimming. I haven't seen it like the last three times I went on it.
They got rid of it. They had to have. I haven't seen it either.
Yeah, but you
I just
remember
it. Yeah. It's supposed to freak you out. It's
yeah,
the
you see the mermaid swimming. It's not been there.
Maybe they changed it. Maybe they're doing work on it.
I hope not, dude. I didn't like it when they added Jack Sparrow, who is a much better animatronic than all the other animatronics.
Yeah, no, he stands out.
He looks legit.
He stands out like a sore thumb. You're like... oh, fake thing. Jack Sparrow. That might be Johnny Depp.
And he's always like hiding, like in the middle of everything. They can't fucking see him.
He's in the
not
barrel.
Actually. Yeah. It's like I'm gonna hide in between two barrels while I'm standing up.
We had this discussion. I don't think we've had a discussion with Ben. Did you notice that there's wenches for sale in that ride?
Yes, absolutely.
We want the redhead.
Yes. Yeah, they're selling prostitutes in that.
No,
ride.
They're not prostitutes. They're just women whose husbands that they have murdered, and they are selling.
Aren't
to
their hands
to
tied?
Fuck. Huh? Yeah, their hands are tied.
Yeah,
definitely.
And it teaches objectification because none of the pirates want the other women there. They want the redhead with the Coke bottle figure.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's
offensive as shit.
Very offensive.
But they'll never take it out.
No, they
because
better not.
It's there.
Because now it's history.
And if they weren't willing to change...
what do you guys think about the Carousel of Progress or whatever the
I
shit?
I love that ride.
Carousel of Progress
it's
is great.
It's so awesome. Interesting.
It's hilarious.
So interesting.
I took Amy on that for the first time, and the whole time she was like cringing.
It's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
I fucking...
coming at the end of every day.
I love essentially like the boat rides and really cheesy rides at Disney World.
Oh shit, yeah.
Like the land that
I just
discovered.
The land was so good. You get to sit for so long.
Oh, it's so relaxing.
Oh, it's very relaxing. Spaceship Earth, I love.
Spaceship Earth is terrific.
Yeah.
And you get to do the thing at the end.
Yeah, you get to see the tomorrow that you built for yourself.
Did you ever put Spaceship Earth in like a crazy language?
No.
Oh, we got to do that
next time. German, so.
Well, like you can listen to it. My father-in-law, last time we were together on it, and he put Japanese, and I'm not going to say it because I don't want to be racist, but it sounded so cool while we were on
it. So cool. It was like Goku is about ready to transform right in front of me.
It's amazing.
The whole time?
Amazing.
That's not Copernicus.
She says I didn't cringe, I loved it, says Amy.
Amy didn't cringe, she loved it? I'm confused. Well, okay, well, maybe I misinterpreted your body language.
It's like a private discussion. It's
really private discussion.
This is a discussion you should
have. Now I'm scared.
You should have
privately.
Should we bring her up here?
We should get Amy up here to talk about it.
Amy!
They're white me!
Oh, they need to teach a kid how to step up for themselves with a bottle of Jack and a 44. I'm not sure that's necessary from Disney.
No, that's not the
but
point.
But back in my day, Disney took... there were conflicts, and they took care of it. You know? Like, Pete the Cat was legitimately like a... he was a murderer, and he smoked a cigar the whole time. Yeah.
And at the end of Mickey's Christmas Carol, he's the freaking ghost of Christmas Future, mm-hmm. who is absolutely terrifying.
Oh, totally.
Terrifying.
He's like, it's the worst. Your grave, Ebenezer, and pushes him right into the grave. That is some scary shit.
Yo, that shit terrified me as a kid.
So scary.
So fucking scary.
Like, that's a kid's cartoon, and they're talking about pushing people into their own grave.
It was ridiculous.
The mind, that, wow.
Why don't they talk about Little Mermaid ride? That's just legit. That shit is legit.
Little Mermaid ride's great.
Little Mermaid ride's great. It's air conditioned. And you go through the whole movie in like 5 minutes.
I mean, they skip a little bit.
They skip some things, yeah. But they hit the big points.
Yo, real talk. Do you think Eric fucked Ursula when she was in her human form?
Probably. I don't know.
No, they didn't seem like too.
Yeah, but he was brainwashed.
I know, but they didn't.
You don't. You telling me Ursula, who spent most of her life. As, by the way, why did she choose to look like, she had magic. She turned herself into a hot chick. She just had Ursula's voice. Until she had Ariel's voice. You telling me that Ursula didn't take advantage of Eric and fucked him?
Anything's possible.
I don't think he hit that shit. I think she hit that shit.
We don't even need these right now.
I mean, that's accurate. I think that's an accurate assumption of witch power.
Yeah. Scar was the only Disney villain to succeed. He killed the king and took his kingdom.
He did. He absolutely did what he set out to do. He absolutely did.
Scar was smart.
The only flaw in his plan was he trusted the hyenas to kill Simba. And they didn't.
They did not.
Do you realize Simba. The conversations we're having about kids' movies, about, like,
I rooted
dying.
For the bad guys all the time when I was a kid.
See, I do that when I watch wrestling.
Like, I wanted Vader Repulsa to live all the time, or to win all the time. I wanted the Green Ranger to win when he was a bad Green Ranger.
Wait, so what other Disney villains have you rooted for? Like Hades and Hercules?
I don't like Hercules. I think it's a terrible movie.
It's not terrible, but I don't it's not
like
good.
It. No, I don't like it.
All right, so who else?
Let's see here. Like, most of them.
Like, give me an example.
Okay.
The witch in Snow White? Like, that's not like really one I'd root for.
Here's the deal. It's not that I rooted for Jafar.
But
I feel like he made some really bonehead decisions with his wishes. Like, he wasted the first one. He was like, I want to be Sultan. Cool. Now I'm going to be a sorcerer. He probably could have gotten his shit, like,
if he decided to be a sorcerer.
Nobody fucking thinks through their wishes. Guys, I'm telling you right now, you need to think the logistics of your wishes if you were to find a genie.
You don't want
a
double wish.
You don't want to
double,
wish.
You want to wish for one thing, and then the second thing could have got you the first thing.
No, you don't want that.
You should also just use the first wish and keep the other two, just in case. That's
just
really
in case.
It.
Yeah.
One wish could easily
yeah,
help you.
You really need to think your wishes through. Like, and that was Jafar's fault. Like, okay, so you're telling me, motherfucker who spent half of his adult life looking for a magic lamp, that gave him three wishes, and he knew that it gave him three wishes, that he's gonna make some fucking dumb mistakes like that? Like, he doesn't have that shit planned out with, like fucking, this one's gonna outrule that
one. Maybe, like, the moment, like, got him. Like, I finally did it, I wanna be the, you know, what was the first one? The Sultan?
Sultan, yeah.
Yeah, and then he's like, wait, why did I do that? I meant sorcerer! And then he got tricked.
Dude, why would he vote? Why would he wish to be a genie?
Who else did you root for? Maleficent?
Maleficent? You know, I didn't really care for
Even though now she's a good guy. Don't worry, guys. Disney fixed it. Maleficent's a good guy.
Yeah.
Same message as Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. No bad guys out there.
Yo, have you watched Once Upon a Time?
I've watched episodes. I want to sit down and watch it through. Danielle watches it.
You'll be upset with some of it, but it's all right.
Emmy watches it too. I can't get into it.
I want to, and I think I
it's
can.
It's
because
I don't understand. I mean, I don't understand enough. I watched one episode.
It's not just
and it
Disney,
was like
though.
Cruella De Vil got eaten by her own dogs or some shit. Sorry if that's a spoiler. It might be. I don't know.
No, no, she didn't get eaten by her dogs. She got pushed off a cliff.
Damn, that's how the next episode, that's how they set it up. Okay.
I'm gonna push her off a cliff.
But,
with magic.
And you yelled at me for giving a spoiler from Batman Begins last week.
This was two seasons ago.
Just saying.
I don't care, dude. Fucking
but,
catch up.
We said 5 years on the statute of spoiler.
Is reasons. It? 5 years?
That's what I think. It's 2 minutes for this guy. No, but, I want to get into it, but I just feel like I need to sit down and commit time to that. Time is something I don't have right now.
You need to watch Billions before you watch others. You don't.
I gotta get to Billions.
Watch Billions. That shit's great.
I'm watching Turn right now. Have you ever watched Turn?
What's Turn?
Turn is
all right. Hang on. Let me get it for you. Okay, cool. I watched it. Now, what's the next show I'm gonna watch?
Bad joke.
Terrible joke.
Turn is about the spy network during the Revolutionary War.
All right.
It's on AMC.
You gotta have a bad joke.
Have you
every
ever
once
watched
in a while.
The Tudors?
Tudors is
no.
Great.
That shit is dope.
Great.
Holy
great show.
Shit.
You watch Vikings?
No.
This is the problem with all three of us. Two of us watch a damn show, and the third one doesn't fucking watch it. We can never all talk about a show.
And you don't watch TV anymore.
I don't.
I keep telling you on your day off, like, God. Binge watch
nothing more relaxing.
This show.
Nothing
this
more
guy
relaxing.
Listens to me. He banged through Vikings in 2 weeks.
I
banged
don't know.
Through it on
I
his
went
day off.
I have time. I got kids. I got kids.
Lock them in the room.
Seriously.
Teach them a Disney princess lesson.
I got.
Yeah, there's no bad guys, kids.
I'm
let's watch a movie.
Fucking...
Spartacus is a bit much. Spartacus, by season two, you're basically watching porn. Basically.
Skinamax.
Does Game of Thrones start this weekend?
Shit, does it?
I think
I've
it starts
never
Sunday.
Seen Game of Thrones.
Chat,
no,
please
no, no,
confirm.
No. Yeah, it's soon. It's soon as shit.
Chat, never please confirm.
It's this month.
Did we already talk about that?
Yes, I yell at you all the time.
You yell at me
one.
About Game of Thrones. I've never seen it.
Failure.
But like we discussed with Neon before he calls me out again, just because I like something doesn't mean that you have to like it too. God, Neon's like the fucking police on this.
He really is, dude.
One Punch Man. You guys know you made me watch One Punch Man because you kept calling me One Punch Man because I'm fucking bald.
April 24th. We have,
this shit's
we have
good.
Weeks. We have 2 weeks.
It's good.
April 24th.
I'll watch it. You could watch
the
it in
Office?
Like 6 hours.
Have you ever watched The Office?
Never watched The Office.
You?
Both of them.
Thank you. Again, two of us and him.
I watched The British Office on Cartoon Network and Adult Swim, and I thought it was a joke.
Like a fake TV show that wasn't real?
Have you? No. Have you? Because Adult Swim does that.
No, that shit,
they do that shit all the time.
Did you ever see the thing on Adult Swim when they did the fake like sitcom from the 90s? And I forget what it was called. Oh my God. Someone's going to remember in chat, they're going to say it. And it like progresses 15 minutes long into this insane thing. Again, we can't watch it because it's copyright,
sure.
But damn, it's hysterical. You want another tweet? Or you want to pull
Space
someone
Ghost
in?
Coast to Coast.
All
watch Space Ghost Coast to Coast?
I mean, like, too many cooks isn't... No, what's...
Too many
like,
cooks,
like,
that was it, thank
like
you.
Like Children's Hospital.
Tim and Eric,
Children's Hospital, yeah.
Yeah.
Too many cooks? That was great.
God. Children's Hospital is as funny as fuck.
You didn't like the too many cooks thing?
No, I thought it was funny.
It was hysterical.
Yeah.
Thank you, chat. I love that chat.
Tim and Eric, I either think it's really funny or like it's
terrible.
It's so funny or I just get horrified. Like, these guys are on acid right now when they're filming it.
Did you know someone said this podcast was better than Tim and Eric? And I was like, you're seriously wrong, but thank you. I was, no.
Oh, shit.
No. Maybe in the future.
No. Not at all.
Maybe.
Dexter! Yeah, I've watched Dexter. I got through Dexter. I liked Dexter a lot.
Everyone's asking. All right, I played Pokemon.
Mm-hmm.
I did. I forgot to bring it back.
You started playing it?
I played it. I probably got about 7 or 8 hours in. So the first question is, do I need to keep going?
Did you
understand the full game?
Did you the very best?
Did you beat the elites at the end? The elite?
What are the elites?
Did you get through the whole game? Did you get all your badges?
No, he got.
No,
he said 7 hours.
I didn't do that. I got a shitload of Pokemon, though.
I mean, I would, dude. I would get
through
it.
I'll keep going.
Yeah.
I have no problem.
I would get through
it. It's not a struggle. I don't know why people were telling you that Kevin hates Pokemon. All I said was, I like it. I see the addiction. It's just not the type of game that I normally play. It's not my cup of tea, was my exact words. So, I'll keep going. I'll beat it. How long does it take to beat it? Average. About
20 hours, maybe?
I'll finish that. That's
yeah, like 20, probably 20 hours to just to get through the story. Of it, and then like it. Then that's when it really opens up. You got to do some online battles, Kevin.
Not a problem. I'll do it. I'll finish it. I'll keep going.
Right, cool. Beat your ass.
I don't know. But is Mewtwo even your... in?
Shut up!
I don't think Mewtwo.
You missed that one. He's gonna beat.
I thought he was gonna beat his ass, but I just lost my 3DS.
Ben left his 3DS on a plane
with
because of my.
Not just the 3DS.
Stupid. With Xenoblade in it.
And?
40 hours down the toilet! Didn't you say and it was my 3DS cap card 3DS. Yep.
What?!
Yeah, I didn't tell you that one yet. I didn't figure out... I didn't figure that shit out until I got home. I was like, I have another one. I think the other one has the cap card in it. And I flipped that bitch around, and I looked, and there was no USB port. So now I'm fucked for 6 months until I can get another one. It makes me so sad.
Oh, those things are like $500.
I know they are.
Holy shit, dude.
$500 down the toilet because they were rushing us off the damn plane.
Look at it, tips. We got one from Juan earlier. He says, love the talk show. Any way to make your guys' screen bigger, though? Love your desktop. We want to see you guys. Ah, don't worry about that.
Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, we're good where we are.
Oh, gross.
You don't need to see us. So good.
Pull someone in.
Pull someone in?
So good.
I'm looking for a Twitter question.
Yo, Warboard, what's up? You're on the jam. Cool.
Rip. Rip. Rip.
Hold on. Before you pull someone in, okay. You have to show this to chat. That's FaZe Computer in the Division, and someone
posted the jam on it. That's some good shit. That's some solid photoshopping.
I'll give them props after. I didn't look at the name.
Some solid photoshopping.
That is Faye from The Division watching the jam, guys.
How did you...
I'm going to retweet it right now.
Oh, that's so good, dude. That's
messed
so
up.
Good.
That's messed up.
She's supposed to be saving New York City, and there she is.
She's listening to the
Duo
jam.
Duo Maxwell. I see you out there.
What about him? Is he in the thing?
He's the one who did that.
Oh, was that Duo Maxwell? I'm going to pull him in. Yo, Duo, what's up, man? You're on the jam.
Yo, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
Yo, good Photoshop job.
Nice shot.
That was a nice Photoshop. Nice that was
shop.
Very clever.
Yeah. I thought that'd be pretty cool.
Mute the background.
Yo, mute the stream in the background, dude. I can hear myself twice, and as much as I love that.
Oh, yeah, my bad. Muting it.
Yeah, we know.
I do love the sound of my own voice. It's true.
There we go. We're muted.
All right, cool, man. What's up, dude? Where are you from?
Nothing much, man. Mobile, Alabama.
Mobile?
Nice.
Mobile, Alabama. I'm sorry.
Mobile.
Mobile, Alabama. So you don't have any Southern accent to you, I don't feel like.
Only a little bit.
I hear a little twang. You
like a little twang
tiny
in
bit
it?
Of a twang?
Like around my family members and stuff. But
okay.
Not for real.
Not for real.
Well, cool, man. You've been around a long time. I appreciate you calling into the show. We got people in chat saying I grew up. Yeah. Kyle Undefined grew up in Mobile. Mobile, Alabama. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm offensive.
You're from the South. It's not really offensive.
Yeah,
it's not offensive at all. I find it hilarious.
I'm from Florida, and we're not considered the South. We're like New York.
Yo,
too.
Duo Maxwell, I need to understand if you've ever seen a leprechaun in Mobile, Alabama.
I have. He was in a
we played that video. That's
a suburb of Mobile called Pritchard.
Hold on. Shh. Keep going.
And the people, God, they circulated pictures. It was in a local newspaper and everything. Some dude had like a sketch drawing that was on the news. It
yep,
was
we played it. We played it last week. We played the video from it.
That's my favorite.
Okay. I guess I missed that part.
Yeah, where the guy's like, everybody wants to see Leprechaun say yeah. That's my favorite guy. That remix. Do you know that dude and the whistles go whoop, dude?
Yep.
Like both those dudes try to capitalize on those videos going viral.
Wouldn't
and then
you.
They failed miserably. It was great.
And it should have been me.
There's the other dude in the video who's like,
out of it and stuff. They sell T-shirts like downtown and stuff. And I was like, somebody.
I want an Alabama leprechaun T-shirt. There, I love the other dude in the video who's all like, I'm gonna get a backhoe and dig up the tree.
I'm gonna get a backhoe.
I want to know where the gold at. I want to know where the gold at. Give me the gold. I want the gold.
He knows.
I want to know where the gold at. Give me the gold. This is my flute. It's a special leprechaun flute. Passed down to me by my grandfather. The
wars of evil spirits.
Wars of... Dude, that shit that he... That was a piece of scaffolding link. It was a link
with
for
some
scaffolding.
Holes drilled in it. Yeah. It
yes.
Was nothing
it was so good.
It
was construction equipment, his flute.
The whole thing went on here. I'm absolutely terrified of leprechauns.
Oh, for real?
Like the leprechaun movie and everything scares
me. Oh, those
stuff.
Yeah, those are pretty scary.
Damn.
Yeah. I don't like the fact of like a little thing that can run around and hide behind shit and I can't see it. It's weird.
It's weird when you phrase it like that.
Bro, I feel you. That's scary.
But
shit.
No, in that, have you ever seen that movie?
What, Leprechaun?
Yeah.
Which one? There's so many.
Any of them.
What about Leprechaun in the Hood?
That one was kind of cheesy.
That's a classic.
Yeah. None of the other Leprechaun movies were cheesy, but Leprechaun in the Hood specifically.
No. It's terrible.
They should have done a movie crossover with Leprechaun and Air Bud. Because Air Bud had a bunch of unnecessary movies and Leprechaun. Like Leprechaun in Space?
Straight up, yeah.
There was Leprechaun in space.
I got you.
Yeah, there was. I'm pretty sure there was Leprechaun.
Yeah, people are saying it.
Yeah, people already at Leprechaun in space.
Definitely hasn't caught up.
Yeah, there was Leprechaun in space. Yeah. Yeah, definitely was Leprechaun in space.
I'm so glad the city that I'm from, that's what we're famous for.
Well,
damn
fantastic. Do you have any questions for us, Duo?
No, I just want to say, you know, I really enjoy watching all three of you guys. I've been watching since...
Yay, all three!
You know, yay!
He did it!
I started watching Kevin when Goth started mentioning him, and all three of you guys are great to watch. Before I go, can I tell a joke?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. What condition does a chameleon have that doesn't allow him to change colors?
What is that?
A reptile dysfunction.
Yo.
And that's the worst joke of the year for you right there.
I loved Perfect. It. Perfect. I loved it.
Thank well, you, Duo.
Thank you for
welcome.
That joke,
Thanks
Duo.
Thanks for having me on, guys.
You have Anytime. A good night.
All right, you too. Later.
Cody Fawbush on Twitter said, the one thing my girlfriend learned from the jam is to never buy cheap shampoo.
Why? Because her hair would get dried out?
I think it goes back to our masturbation conversation.
Is his girlfriend Listen.
she DJ Diddles in there with the shampoo?
You DJ Diddles?
What?
She DJ Diddles? She DJ Diddles with the fucking...
When did you decide that a lady masturbating was called DJ Diddles?
It's a Dane Cook joke.
It's a Dane Cook joke.
I am happy I don't know it. I'm proud of myself for not knowing DJ Diddles.
I'm proud of you for not knowing that was a Dane Cook joke.
I have a great Dane Cook impression.
Yeah.
I was just being myself. That was my whole joke. Minus the cocaine.
Do you think he does a lot of coke?
Dude. When he was on the fucking, have you seen his stand-up?
Dude, he's like
he was obvious. He's the
stage.
Most obvious person on
he's
cocaine.
He's so he's not like he used to be super thin, but
yeah, he stopped doing cocaine and, got fat.
Okay,
that's what happens when you stop doing coke.
Dane Cook's first album still holds up. No, his early stuff was really good.
His early stuff's great.
Yeah. The first album. And
the
that's
first
where the
live
DJ
special
Diddles
I saw where he jumped, he dumped water on himself and walked around
alien?
Stage acting like an alien.
That shit was great.
It was great. Yeah, I love that shit.
Yeah.
Jarl's in Charge on Twitter wants to know, if you could only listen to one song for the rest of your lives, what would it be? Ben?
One song for the rest of my life?
I know mine.
I mean, I don't know. This is...
No, I'm not gonna listen to the whole thing.
I was expecting that. I don't know, man. Like, one song for the rest of my life? I don't have an answer.
I'd listen to Scatman for the rest of my life.
Fuck you.
Scatman?
Hell yeah.
Really, Scatman?
When Scatman, you can feel his mustache rubbing against your ear.
No, I don't think Scatman, dude. I don't think Scatman. I don't know about Scatman.
I love that song.
I don't know. I think it would, like, if you had the, okay, so, question, because I have to get more information on the question,
mm-hmm.
And you guys are going to have to answer this.
Can you turn it off?
Can you turn it off?
No.
Because if you can never turn the song off, it would have to be Dave Brubeck, Take 5.
I've never heard
that. Because I can sleep.
Oh, okay.
Ah.
I've never heard the song, but I get your drift.
It would be Take 5. I mean, it's a relatively long song, and it's jazz. So it would need to be something that can also be background music.
Yeah, I'm just...
Andrew WK, Party Hard?
I'm just going to go with Party Hard for final answer. But I will always be so amped.
But if you think about Andrew WK's, like, lifestyle and mantra, you could be that guy.
Yeah, I could be that guy if I didn't hear anything.
You could
other
be
than
the
partying.
Head of the party party.
Yeah.
Which, by the way,
party.
Thumbs up.
No, it's time to party.
Andrew WK, if you're listening to this,
good job with the party party.
Nice.
Did you hear about the party party?
No.
Andrew W.K. started his own political party called the Party Party.
Party Party?
It's all about partying.
It's all about Andrew W.K.'s party philosophy.
Party.
Go look it up. We're not going to talk about it now. Dark Maven on Twitter wants to know, at what age do you all start... I think he meant, did you all start having sex?
15.
You can answer next.
19.
My answering is, I waited until I was 22.
That's not bad.
And married.
That's not bad.
I think it is. I regret it.
That's really not bad.
Do you know your number, Kevin?
Yeah. Two.
Like, concisely?
Two.
Two.
Somewhere.
We're both looking at you.
I don't. I'm...
Oh! This guy! You were that much of a pimp?
I had a... You know? Played a lot of music and...
I played a lot of music. How does that answer the question?
I don't answer any fucking question.
Seriously. I played a lot of music too.
Like, listen, I know it's under 30.
Wow!
But I don't think I could name everybody.
That I understand not naming, but under 30?
Yeah.
That's a large number.
Yeah, I don't think I can name everybody.
Jesus.
I came out on the other side unscathed, though.
You are a lucky, lucky man.
I always chose correct.
What does that look like?
Yeah.
You're at the bar, you just got done finishing a show, and now you gotta choose correct. What's that look like?
Please.
Help the young people in chat choose correct.
They're perfect, perfect.
I don't fucking know. Get lucky. I don't know. You fucking...
Find the hottest person in there and roll that dice.
You hear that, guys?
You got BD in the morning, you nailed it.
You hear that, guys? Get lucky. You're literally looking at the luckiest man alive right here. Literally. Get lucky.
Under 30 at 15, Christ, why? I got married. Well, I met Sam relatively young.
Get lucky.
So, that's a few years.
Yeah, that's
a year? Like,
that's a good
on.
Question. How many get luckies?
I mean, that's like what? Like, if I...
All right.
I mean,
let's
like average,
assumption,
average 3 to 4 years?
Let's make the assumption that every partner you had, we'll say under 30, let's be super nice and do 21. So let's make the assumption that every person you were with had sex with an equivalent amount of people. That means you had sexual contact with over 100,000 other people. How does that make you feel?
You have so many Eskimo brothers, it's ridiculous.
It happens.
So many Eskimo brothers.
It happens.
Fathom that for a second. Think how often he runs into an Eskimo brother and
No idea. Oh, shit, because you've always lived here, too.
How does that math work?
It's a factor. It's a factorial.
Thank you.
Is that why people don't have sex all the time?
I mean, no.
Well, we all can get lucky like you.
Like, when you look into numbers like that, they're factorial, so it grows exponentially for each person that you add. So, like, small numbers, it still starts to make sense. Like, 3, I think the factorial is like 12 or 9 or something. But then when you get up to like 21, it explodes. It's ridiculous. I used to teach sex ed, and that was something we used to scare kids and to not, you know, into wrapping their willy. Hey, man, you have sex with 22 chicks, you might as well be having sex with 500,000. What? Yeah, wrap that shit up. Otherwise, it's going to fall off.
Okay, I guess so.
I don't know.
Spazzy said she wants to fist bump Goth.
He doesn't even realize how lucky he was. This is great.
I know.
Fucking whatever. Willie's clean, never drips.
No, they know
he's clean.
Yo, Dot Funky, I don't understand the life of a musician. I was in punk and hardcore bands. I toured. I know the life.
Dude, he did tour.
Don't fear, homie. They don't understand the life of a musician.
I know the deal. My number was still 2.
Kevin knows
not,
the deal.
I got lucky and maybe somewhere under 30.
Look, man, like, listen, when I was younger, I always wanted a relationship.
God, sex
like,
with the president.
That just didn't happen. You know? And it just so happened that I was really charming. What was I supposed to do? Not fuck?
You still are charming, I'll say that much.
Well, you know, sometimes you can talk. I don't think you've ever been there for it, but I know you have, where I meet a new female and I'm like, listen, whatever you're thinking, I'm married.
You did that at Disney.
I've been there for that a few times.
When you were drunk and showing people your sword umbrella.
Oh, okay.
You did that to some girl in Italy. Yeah.
It's like, listen.
I know what you're thinking, but I am married. In fact, that's my wife right over there. No, I wasn't a drummer. I did vocals.
Vocals.
I played bass, but that was never anything.
Nice.
What?
I missed it. Oh, shit, man. I don't know.
Why don't you... Oh, God. What did Chef say?
What did he say?
I don't know.
Where is he?
Scroll up.
I don't know.
My best friend in the whole world. He's...
Where is it?
He's saying things. I don't know. Spazzy said, LOL, Chef.
There he is. Always fuck if it's an option.
I'm with Team God. Yeah, well... Yeah, we know. Your number's pretty high, too, there, buddy.
Look, man. You know, it's just the life
that
some people...
That dude used to drive up to Boston from New York to get his shit on.
I drove to Fort Lauderdale.
That's so far. You could.
That's like 4 hours to Fort Lauderdale.
You couldn't find anything here?
I don't know. It was available, and I was 18.
I don't know.
When you're 18,
yeah, you'd drive 4 hours.
You would drive 4 hours, man. And I wasn't even sleeping there. You drive there, you're sleeping from driving, and you gotta drive back.
I'm 26 and. Dollar tip said, when it comes down to choosing between Goku and Puka Shell necklace, I go Goku 8 times out of 10.
Oh, man.
Oh, shit, man. Good
totally
stuff.
Worth reading.
Oh, no, that was absolutely worth reading. Oh, good stuff. Let's pull someone in.
Pull someone in.
Let's do it.
Wait, scroll up. I want to see if that person that we talked about earlier is in there. No,
I don't know. I'll see him.
All right. Yo, Chef, get in Discord.
Yo, Focus, what's up, man? You're on the jam.
Yo, what's going on?
Yo, where you from, man?
Cincinnati, Ohio.
Hell yeah, Cincinnati.
Cincinnati.
I've never been to Cincinnati, dude. What goes on in Cincinnati? What are you guys famous for out there?
Wow, that much?
The Nothing. Bengals?
The LeBrons?
The Bengals, maybe?
That's Cleveland.
You said Cincinnati. I missed it.
Wow.
I'm an asshole. Teams never really do anything. So
the Reds, the Bengals.
Think about the first round and pretty much everything.
I feel like the Bengals at one point were pretty good.
Nah, they fail all the time.
Yeah, they fail all the time.
They make it like
wasn't Ocho Cinco on the Bengals?
Was he?
Chad Johnson.
Yeah, he was.
Chad Johnson followed me on Twitter for literally 30 seconds the other day.
He's a big Madden player. Yo, use your verified powers and make that happen.
Yeah, he followed me for 30 seconds. I don't know why, but he followed me for 30 seconds. Chad Ocho Cinco Johnson followed.
Yo, use that verified thing and make friends with Chad. He's a big gamer.
I know he is.
He doesn't do anything.
He wants to start streaming.
Dude, you get in on that before anyone else does. Help him.
Because his football career went down the damn shitter.
Yeah, his football career is
He's
over.
He's old, though. He's in his mid to late 30s for football. That's old.
It was that one that was always causing problems, was always on the front page of ESPN.
Yeah, he's like Terrell Owens.
He was not as bad as Terrell
Owens. No, I think Ocho Cinco is probably as bad as Terrell Owens.
No. Terrell Owens was way worse.
You think so?
T.O.'s still bitching that he can't get in the Hall of Fame.
Yo, T.O. used to work out in his driveway, man. He would take questions in his driveway. I think people giving T.O. a hard time.
Ocho Cinco's super charitable, too. He does stuff for charity all the time. I'm just saying, I like Ocho Cinco. I don't mind.
You like Chad Johnson?
I don't mind T.O., but I like Ocho Cinco. I think he's a swell guy. So, Ocho, if you're watching this since you followed Goth, I would love to play you in Madden sometime.
He ain't watching. He don't give a fuck.
Ocho.
He watching now.
Ocho Cinco is just as bad as T.O. back in the day. Says Boltzilla plays in your face.
I don't care what Boltzilla plays.
He wow.
Disregarded. I'm kidding.
Damn. All wide receivers are divas. Who else is there?
I agree with that statement.
Who's Randy?
That's true.
Randy Moss. Randy Moss.
He wasn't a diva.
I think Randy Moss is a little bit of a diva.
He wasn't a
diva. I mean, he was talented as a motherfucker.
You know who's a diva? And I'm a Giants fan. Odell Beckham. He is such a diva. God, he's talented, but damn, is he a diva.
Who?
Odell Beckham.
I don't know who that is.
He's the dude that made the one-handed catches all year.
Oh, okay. Was it all year? What are you laughing at,
Ben? It was a reception fade. Just the phrasing. I didn't see it.
Ocho Cinco did that thing where he punched his new wife.
I mean, that pretty much elevates him to top scumbag.
Yeah, that's pretty scummy. That's,
didn't know about that.
Yeah, he did that thing where, like, it's just that punch your new wife thing.
Didn't know about that.
Yeah, that's yeah.
Everything win. I said about Ocho Cinco. We don't need to play Madden, dude. It's
I was
all good.
Unaware. I was unaware.
It's all good.
Did he really?
Didn't know about that.
You got any questions for us, Focused? He went away.
I'm here.
We shot the shit for too long.
just wanted to say thanks, man, for all the entertainment you guys provide. I have a great time watching each and every one of your streams.
Hey, man, I appreciate that.
Thank you, Focus.
Everybody listening on iTunes is going to feel like we staged all these questions.
Fucking for sure, dude.
Because people come in, they're like,
you fucking
no.
suck, just kidding.
All right, man, well, you have a good night.
Thanks, bud.
Yo, Chef is in Discord.
Is he? Let's pull him in.
The Chef of Wayne Faces. No, you're not. You're not Where? In there. You got to be in the Jam Lounge, dude. You're nowhere to be found. You got to be in Goth's Jam Lounge, Chef.
Chef's a liar, dude.
You are the worst. If you didn't cook such delicious food, we wouldn't be best friends.
Oh, man, this guy. Yo, we went to 585 again this week. Holy shit, man.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, the Wagyu. We always try to eat Wagyu on the Twitch dollar.
We both got cards that told us the name and date of death of the cow we ate.
Yep.
You watch Portlandia?
No.
Oh my god, they have a whole episode about the chicken, and they're talking about... You have to choose a chicken menu based on their name and the things that they liked and everything like that.
Oh, hell yeah.
That's what that reminded me.
My cow liked being delicious and also flavorful.
We had a tip question from Slain Spy. He says, I just wanted to know what your thoughts of Batman vs. Superman are. Proceeding all that was a lot of nice words. I appreciate it, dude. Ben still hasn't seen it.
I haven't seen it. I was out of town when everybody went to see it.
No, you were working.
It.
You had just gotten
working.
Back in town.
I just got back in town. That's what it was.
Yeah.
We talked about it last week.
Yeah, we did talk. Yeah, I liked Bat. I liked it.
I thought it was good. Yeah. I didn't think it was terrible, and I didn't think it was great. I thought it was good.
I don't know. I liked Affleck as Batman a lot. I did.
Old,
I think
bitter, angry Batman.
I feel like he was more of a like complete Batman and Bruce Wayne character.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Because I still feel like Bale was a shitty Bruce Wayne.
That I disagreed with you last week.
Yeah, you did. Do you agree with me now?
No.
Okay. Oh, dude. I'm glad we came to the library tonight to shoot this.
I'm so good.
So are we going to go to a different location to film every week now?
I think we should. I think we should go to a different location.
Ben, how often are you going to join us?
I don't know. I mean, if you'll have me back, whenever you'd like, a third.
No, never. Yeah, of course.
Let's just see what the comments have to say on, on
wow,
iTunes.
Wow, worst episode.
Yo, that third voice was shit. Everything he said made me want to eat glass.
4,200 dead from glass eating this week.
Yeah, it was great. Wow, I'd love to. I'd come back as frequently as you all will have me.
Absolutely.
Okay.
But you just have to commit to... Oh, before we do anything else, this guy wants to stop with the bad beer.
I do want
to stop. He wants to try and do new beer that we haven't tried.
I want to try new beer. Like, here's the deal.
I feel like he's abandoning what we started here at the Jam. I feel like the bad beer is a very important thing.
I tried a new beer. Was it bad?
Until Ben poured liquor into it, yes.
Yeah.
Well, then clearly you just need me to fix it.
You're the catch right there. It's too far away, though.
It's too far away. That.
No, man, it's not that I'm quitting. It's just like I'm sick of waking up with a stomach ache and feeling like shit.
That's the commitment we have.
I wake up every time burping and tasting vomit. You know what it's like to wake up in the morning and taste vomit in your mouth and there not be any vomit anywhere?
Yeah, because I sit next to you and do the same thing. I do know what it's like.
Why are you sitting next to me in bed, Kevin?
You didn't set yourself up for that one. Wow. That was real easy. Yeah.
You're not supposed to tell anyone.
I almost jumped in mid-sentence.
Sam was a really believable cover until now.
It's okay. Why does everyone here wear beards, guys?
Oh,
uncomfortable!
Uncomfortable!
You need to have a gold Four Loko. Did any of you, I know you had Four Lokos last week, but did any of you guys have Four Lokos previously when it still had caffeine in it?
No.
Does it have caffeine anymore?
No.
No, they had to, took it out.
You think you would have fallen asleep right away afterwards?
Because it was blackout juice. It has an equivalent, it had equivalent amount of caffeine, like it was dosed so that you got just as hyped as you would get tired so you could just fucking keep pounding drinks. I had Four Loko when it still had caffeine in it. And I legit ran 5 miles because I felt so good. It was back when I was in shape. I was like, Four Loko makes me want to work out drunk. This is great.
Did it kill anyone? Is that why they...
I was ready to die.
I'm sure it killed someone.
Is that why they
I didn't. Fuck, you can't remember anything now. That's why you gotta do Red Bull and vodka shots now. It's some weak shit.
I think Chef Wayne Face is in there.
Is he?
Let's make sure. This is your last
It did
chance.
Kill people. Heart palpitations. Heart palpitations.
There he is.
Yo, Wayne, what's up? You're on the jam.
Wayne, meet Corey and Ben. Corey and Ben, Wayne.
What's up, Wayne?
Oh, don't do this! Don't
Wayne!
Do this! Don't do what you're about
Wayne!
To do, Wayne!
Son!
No!
Son!
I vouched for you!
I heard so
I
much,
I vouched
Wayne!
For you! No! No! Wayne! Oh, you gotta do it. It's past the point.
Rip Wayne. Rip Wayne.
Anymore.
Rip.
Wayne. Wayne.
That's rough, dude. You gotta make sure that mic's working.
I vouch for you, dude.
Oh, shit, man.
I'm so embarrassed.
God, I had an idea. Tips from this episode towards next week's episode. If people tip along with shitty beer next week. I don't know, man. Fucking, I don't know, dude. Because then we gotta find that beer locally.
Zero.
Because I looked for Mad Dog this week.
Mad Dog.
Yeah. You said you were going to have to import it from, like...
Yeah, from a toilet.
Bombay or
I'm going to have to go to a toilet
store. Is there an awfulbeer.com where you can just order, like, an awful beer of the month? Because I would pay money for that.
Google
should
machine.
Look for it.
Yeah, let's see.
Hello, Hitler Tea Kettle.
We'll go to...
Buy them on eBay for $200.
Wow. $1 more than they sold it for? Those guys are making lots of money.
Noogie Live. I've been with the same amount of girls as Kevin and Broman, and I'm 16.
So? It's not a competition, man.
Dude, it absolutely is.
You know, you start collecting women, then that makes you an awful human being.
Beer
quality, not
beer.
Quantity, my friend.
It was great. I had sex with a lot of people. How many of them were awake?
That's different. Like, that's completely different. There's Beer of the Month Club, but there's no, like, bad Beer of the Month Club.
Keep going. It's Google. They probably can't afford
bad, it. Bad, batter, best beer, terrible, there's nothing. Everybody wants good beer.
Why?
I don't know.
Why? Why is there not a scenario where people want to drink bad beer?
They want to try out the shit beer, yeah.
Should have got you.
More details, there's no details. Yeah, it's totally different. You're not collecting women, it's just that you happen to sleep with women.
Whatever happens, happens.
Let me ask you this. Did both of you intentionally saved yourselves?
Yes.
Kind of. Yeah, because I grew up Christian. He did too.
Okay.
Very.
I didn't.
So it was like kind of saving yourself, but when it happened, it happened. I wasn't married.
Oh, no, man. God would have chopped my penis off.
You knew your current wife before your first wife, correct?
Yeah, yeah. We were like, check this out. We went to Disney with her ex-boyfriend and my ex-girlfriend.
So you knew.
Yep. At least I don't have, like, 100,000 Eskimo brothers.
Ben, how far into your current relationship did you get divorced from your previous one?
I don't understand what you mean. I'm very confused.
I'm just saying, I was presented with opportunity, and both of you were in a situation that I wanted to be in earlier in life, but that opportunity never came up. You know, I was never... I was with, like, maybe three girls in my life that were I would consider to be good long-term relationships. The rest of them, it just ended up not being like that. They wanted fun, and I was like, cool, fun's fun. So that's what I went with.
No, that's totally fine, man. I'm not trying to judge you.
No! I'm just saying. I'm just saying. God's treading that dirty water. That's not dirty water, man. It's just statistically, both of them found the loves of their life in situations.
Is what it is. That's all, you know? It is. We're it only is joking, but honestly, it is what it is at the end of
yeah,
the
I don't
day.
Give a shit. You can have sex with as many people as you want.
I don't care. I mean, I'm kind of leaning closer towards Ben now because I learned that news, but other than that, it's...
I mean, like I told you.
I don't care.
God, these slut. Totally judging. Totally judging.
Totally judging. I'm not judging. I'm not going to slut shame Goth.
Still mad at Wayne, but...
There's a website called Rate Beer. And has a list of worst beers in the world.
That's perfect. That's perfect.
Need.
That's perfect.
That's what we need.
I want to look at that. Ratebeer.com.
Didn't text
somebody in Guinness said that they had a bad beer. Does Guinness Book of World Records have the worst beer?
I don't think so. Because that's an opinion. That's not like... It's not something you can track.
I got a nice... I got a, while we're looking at...
Ratings. Oh, you just fucking... You put it in reverse. Rate beer.
Can you put it in reverse?
I don't know.
It's like to say that the first beer there is Hebrew Funky Jubilation.
Yeah.
Okay. I have had some Hebrews beer before.
They're good.
It is very good beer.
They're good.
And kosher. Because when you get wasted, you want to make sure no bad parts of the cow or pig went into that fermentation
Wait,
process.
Wait, are there actually kosher beers? Worry about that.
Yeah, there
Hebrew
are kosher beers,
kosher
yeah.
Beer. Kosher beer.
Does normal, does, how, what?
Some Listen, people care I about went that. To seminary, but I cannot tell you any of the things that would make beer not kosher. I would have to go get a Bible and look Leviticus and try and find
that shit. I
don't
understand.
I mean, we could look at it.
All right, hang on. All right, hang on. I'm going to look up non-kosher grains. All right, hang on. I'll be right back. I don't know why I said I was leaving. I'm standing right here. Right, non-
Ben's going to go out in the hallway and check this out.
Non-kosher grains. Oh, my God. It auto-completed for me. That's
it's grains?
So what that means is a common question.
It's relatively common.
Freaking yeah, I know crazy. Links in chat, but this is on a separate computer, so that's kind of a pain in the ass.
Kosher grains.
I own a brewery and you have to make your own bad beer.
Wheat, barley, oats, rye, and spelt cannot be consumed during Passover. Yeah, I actually don't think there's any non-kosher grains given except for Passover.
So it's like a marketing ploy.
It sounds like it was a marketing ploy. Yeah.
Honey,
said,
no.
You can probably find a Bible behind you. Nah, man, I don't want to touch a book.
He said give him one more chance. He was on Push to Talk and he fixed it. This okay. is it, Wayne. If you don't fix it, I can never vouch for you.
Oh, no yeast.
No yeast?
Can they do beer with no
how
I mean,
is,
yeast?
How is yeast unleavened. Kosher?
Unleavened. Unleavened. But that's also Passover related. I don't know, man. Maybe Hebrews is designed specifically for if you want
All
to
All right, Wayne, this is it. This
Yo,
is
Wayne,
it.
What's up, man? You're on the jam.
He's going to fail. I don't
Hello?
Oh.
Hello.
What's up? What's up, man?
Hi, Wayne.
Oh, I actually did it. Yeah, I didn't know you had to push a mouse button to talk. What the hell?
That's fucking stupid.
You can change that on, setting.
Yeah, you can change that setting.
Teach you how to computer when I get back to New York.
I mean, he did a podcast with you, so...
Yes, we did do a podcast together, but all he had to do was show up on Skype while I did all the work.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that was Kevin doing all the work for me. That's, right. That's how I roll.
Wow. Oh, you did the same room with Wayne, didn't
no,
you?
No, this one, the one I did with him was the Destiny one we did over Skype.
Yeah, oh, okay. Cool. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
How's it going, guys?
What's up, Wayne?
It's going
What's
good, up? Man.
You played hockey tonight?
Yeah, I'm going a little bit.
Oh, okay.
It's late?
Yeah, I'm going to get all
doing
sweaty.
Doing it midnight with my buddy Robbie.
Yeah, so Goth, I'm totally with you, man. The musician life, I understand. If it's there, you got to take it, you know?
I mean, it's I like fun, you know?
Yeah. And, I was there for some... Kevin probably could have conquested a little bit more, but I don't think he was about that life.
Wow, just put me on the spot there.
Ouch. I'm just saying.
Out there.
I also saw some of the people that you conquested with, and I could say there was some pretty questionable choices there.
Hey... I chose correct, though. I came out clean as well.
You did come out clean.
Yo,
there's one girl. Wait. There's one girl in particular. Her name starts with a C. That's all I'm going to say. I'm shocked you came out clean
on
that one.
Call them people out, man. Just call them out.
Yep, there it is. He knows what I'm talking about.
Did any of the guys here
She did porn.
Did you ever...
What?
What?
Yeah, you got VD. It's just hiding.
Boy.
Am I
lying?
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
She did it after Wayne.
Yes, it was after me. Way after me.
After Wayne. BW.
She also had a kid, too.
AW?
AW. I need to go to bed. Oh, she did have a kid after that.
She did have a kid.
We used to joke that the porn was... I'm not even going to say what I'm about to say. Anyway.
Porn baby! I'll say it for you!
Did she have a porn baby?
Porn baby!
But it really ended up...
No!
We're pretty sure she did.
AW after Wayne.
Oh my God.
Do you know who she was?
Yo!
I know. I'm not going to say her name.
No.
No. We're not going to call
her. I'll tell you both
Okay, you tell me after.
I'm not telling chat.
put that on blast.
Yeah, no. That's,
well, you want to bump someone's Pornhub rating up a little bit tonight?
She stopped. She stopped with the other kids.
She stopped. Can still find. They can still. It's all. It's the internet.
Are you guys ever disappointed when you have like a favorite porn star, and there's like a year where they stop doing porn, and there's not going to be any new porn by them?
A little bit.
Like, that's not a thing that you go through?
Not really, no.
That's not an everyday struggle.
I mean, when I was younger, yeah. Absolutely.
You know? I don't know. I'm not like fucking, it doesn't stop my day, but I'm like, oh, really?
Man, I'm kind of sad now.
Oh, the season's over?
They were great with dicks.
Yeah, you've been disappointed all the time. Like, okay, so, but like at the same time, you're like, good for her, you know? It's like, yeah, you get them. Or you wonder, like, I don't know.
The melancholy experience. You know, this sucks, but you know what? Good for them. Good for,
you know,
them.
Good for them.
Oh,
good
but
for
maybe them. Bad for them.
Oh, maybe oh, bad for them.
Maybe
yeah.
bad for them.
Yeah.
So Wayne,
yeah.
Already I've tried to tell Corey how good your restaurant is.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's pretty good.
It's good. Stop it. It's, but he's never going to make it to Long Island. I feel like there's hope that Ben will go to New York for business or something.
Yes.
And he'll be able to go to your restaurant.
I mean, if business is there, dude.
I feel like you still wouldn't go.
Gosh, it's New York. It's I don't know if you know, it's kind of a big deal. There's always business here.
You're talking to the guy that just called New York or the Florida the second New York before.
Ooh, the second
skipping
New
over
York.
LA.
That's where they go.
Chicago.
You know, no, it's New York too. Dallas. It's where New York goes to die.
Right. That's, yeah. It's the New York retirement.
You just made Florida sound like a horror movie. Do you realize that? Florida, New York too, where New York goes to die. Really? I don't want to move down here. But the houses are so cheap. Oh my god!
Casey.
Wayne. You'll never escape.
Wayne is the executive chef at the restaurant H2O in Smithtown, New York.
Googling!
Yeah, and it actually just got announced that they're opening up a second location.
In Florida?
No.
I've been trying to get him to move down, but he, quote-unquote, doesn't like the warm weather.
All right.
Why? You like snow?
Have this fight with Corey, because I feel like it'll be very interesting.
You like snow?
I do, actually.
Paderewy Beaches. It's also not cold.
I'm a very
large Disney
man.
World?
I'm built like a polar bear.
Disney World.
Okay, well...
So, you know, it's just my natural climate. It's just for me, this is what I like. You know?
All right, I won't argue with it.
You know, it's just...
Yo, what'd you say, thing. Smithtown?
Yeah, that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, Smithtown.
Yo!
How many dollar signs that son of a bitch?
It's got $3 signs, but it's only got...
I only have $4 sign
it's got 3.2 stars.
See you later,
what
Chef Wayne.
Yo, chat! Yo, chat, go bomb this YouTube page and give it 5 stars for the restaurant.
YouTube?
That's Google. That's
whatever, Google, man, I'm drinking.
Oh, you got to check us on Open Table. That's where the real people are.
Open Table's are where real people at? Where yeah, you at on your Open Table?
Yeah, you know, that's like people who actually dine at the restaurant and don't just bash us online. Okay.
So, wait, while we have you here, Wayne, was anything I told about the story on the first episode, second episode, when we got held at gunpoint false?
No, that was 100% true.
Thank you.
The part you almost left out, though, was the most important part. The fact that you were able to come up with a red Corsica. On just like off the hip, just boom.
I don't know. Where
I
that
just
came
saw this
from.
Red Corsica whip by. I didn't even know a Corsica was a car, and then I realized.
Yeah, I don't even know what a Corsica is.
Yeah. And now you'll never
now
forget.
I'll never forget.
Never.
We Corsica. See them on the road now and be like, oh, I remember that one. We got held at gunpoint.
Hey, that red Corsica saved our lives.
Yeah, Wayne, you got any questions for us, Wayne?
No, not really. I mean, I feel like it's kind of weird now that like Kevin's hanging out with you guys all the time. So it kind of, I get like my secondhand stories. I'm like, oh, wow, I feel like I kind of know you guys already.
All right.
Aww.
But, you know.
Hang out.
He's never moving back! He's gonna buy out. But really, he won't.
Nah.
Yeah, probably.
But you gotta come down and visit some, man.
I will.
I'm trying to get him to Destiny Community Con, but his girlfriend wants to go to Aruba or some shit.
Look at Aruba blows, dude.
You know what's in between Aruba and where you're at? Florida.
Florida, yeah. Yeah.
Florida is not the South.
It is the South.
It is not the South. It's south of the United States, but it's not the South.
It's considered part of the South.
It's not the South.
Well, it depends. I would say the Panhandle is definitely the South.
Panhandle's the South.
Because I've been there, and that place
is
just...
Oh, it's a scary place.
Orlando and South is not the South.
No. I lived in
Orlando. I would even cut it at an angle from Jacksonville.
Yeah, but there's areas. Yeah, Jacksonville is a shady.
There are pockets of South down here.
Exactly.
For sure.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, they're definitely. Yeah, yeah. Gainesville is very southy.
You are right next to Alabama. You are the South.
Not by choice. No, I'm supposed to.
Yep. Yeah, South by association.
Yeah, South by association.
Yeah, no, I even lived in I lived in Orlando for like 6 months and traveled between Orlando and Tampa, so I know the area. I like it, but it's just way too hot for me, man. I'm just I'm a big guy and I like winter sports.
I like it humid, dude. I leave here at any time. And
I will
like,
tell
it's
you,
so dry.
I will
here.
Tell you that coming from the Midwest down here, I felt like my skin was constantly coated in lotion because of how humid it was.
Yeah, you
it
take a shower.
It was awesome. I was like, my skin's not cracking open anymore. I feel like my face, like, I don't know. I felt like a lady that was like, it was amazing, and all I did was move to Florida. Like, so, no, the humidity is nice. It's nice.
Yeah, it's like going for a nice fit.
I feel like you and I are both gentlemen that run on the warm side, okay? Uh-huh. And I can tell you that your body adapts relatively quickly, and 99% of the time you're going to be in air conditioning anyway.
I could convince him to move. It's his girlfriend that would never move. That's the real problem.
Tell her about the humidity
and
the skin.
What's her situation?
She's never been to Disney. Let's start there.
Let's start there.
Yeah, that's true.
We'll all take a vacation.
Not everybody gets to, you know, experience the majesty of Disney.
Disney World's the greatest place on earth.
I was ashy as fuck, guys. You have no idea how ashy I was.
Yo, Wayne.
Ashy bro, man. Yeah, what's
Wayne,
up?
Wayne, I love you.
I love you too, bro.
Hey, Wayne, thanks for being here.
Close for life. Thank you, guys. Yo. Have a good night.
You
later,
too.
Buddy. Later, chat.
Guys, go follow him if you're not following him on Twitch, please. Chef Wayne Face.
Chef Wayne Face.
I think it's time for you two to do the thing.
Is it?
Are we going to do that today? I think I'd love to string people along for a little while.
I mean, we can do it next week.
I would love to string people along. I feel like, you know, it's so bright in here and I'm kind of tired and I don't know, man. I don't know. I feel like it's just people need to come back next week. You know, Goth's voice has been a little scratchy. I got a cough.
And Chad's so mad. He's so mad at you, Ben.
Let's go. I'll do it.
All right. Cool. Let's do it.
Let's switch seats. Here, take your headphone.
Oh, these motherfuckers is mad as shit.
They're so mad, dude. They're so mad.
You're gonna like need the mic fully.
No, I don't fucking give a shit.
Yeah, give him the mic fully. To a degree.
I'm going to be sleepy and it's going to be bad, but all right.
All right. Guys, if you don't know, hold on.
We waited weeks. You've been waiting much longer than weeks, motherfuckers.
It's been like two weeks.
It's been like a damn year since I've been down here. You want to hear? Okay. Not going to hear it. I'm going to wait for him to set it up.
Hold on. I'm going to put on both of the things.
Beatbox battle? No, that's not what this is. This is collaboration. And we feeling it, fam. We got Kevin over here with the big smile. We got King Goth on the right looking like fire. Take a step back, go ahead and listen. Just because it's nothing doesn't mean it's gonna listen. Just think about it for a little second. Drinking beers and we talking about what heaven. Doesn't matter what you did last week, cause you tuning in right now. Listen to us speak, yo. Mind gonna melt, mind getting fresh. Go ahead, that we hear to death. Yeah, we hear to death. Coming back at it like every single week. Not like it's Friday, it's Wednesday, we speak. Or maybe Friday, cause Kevin changes shit. I don't like it, he's on that other tip. But that's fine, cause he's got a wife and kids. Goth does too, but I ain't got that shit. I got a lady, maybe I knock her up. Then we take the kids out, going to... Listen, I didn't say that. Amy can't hear it. You know she really fat in the face. She beautiful and...
and she got a nice ass, acting like she's fresh, and you know she's gonna hit that. Maybe when I get back home, I don't know, probably not gonna happen, cause she listening, Holmes.
Say oh done.
So lit. So lit.
What?
Oh my god.
That was wow.
Oh my god.
Alright. I think that's gonna wrap it up tonight's episode. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening to Jam on iTunes and iTunes and iTunes and
pretty
iTunes,
great. YouTube, and also and right Stitcher. Here.